हेलो हेलो। हेलो यस हेलो गाइस, वेलकम ऑन योर मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म। वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड सॉरी फॉर स्मॉल इंटरप्शन। ओके, देयर वाज सम काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम लाइक इन कनेक्टिंग। ओके, सो यस, नाउ वी आर रेडी एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस पर्टिकुलर क्लास गाइस। होप यू ऑल आर लाइक प्रिपेयरिंग वेरी वेल फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर एग्जामिनेशन सीएसएल। ओके, यू नो गाइस, 60 क्वेश्चन यू नीड टू आंसर, 60 मिनट्स एंड 60 मार्क्स। वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, 60 minutes, 60 marks, and 60 questions. Okay, and there is no negative marking. So what I feel like, if you are basic, like concepts are fine, then also you can score well in this particular examination. Okay, yes, the non-tech part is required, but only 5 question. You know, 5 question from aptitude, 5 question from reasoning, and remaining 5 question from general awareness and English. Those 20 questions are non-tech part, and 40 questions will be from your core technical subject. Okay, so yes. So here guys, in this class we are going to solve 40 questions. We are going to discuss 40 questions from thermodynamics and its application. Like, you are going to find question from refrigeration, majorly from thermodynamics, heat transfer, power plant and IC engine. So these are the question we are going to start. Thoda sa quick rahega, because I hope this at this particular moment you are ready with your preparation. Okay, so main bahut zyada aapko time isme nahi de paunga. Cut off bahut high rehne wala hai Rohit, and don't worry about that. Dekho, koi bhi exam ke liye when you are going, you know, to have confidence, self belief जो होता है ना, वो उसके साथ जाओ। इस टाइम पे उसको कम मत होने दो, because that is required, that is a priority. Because if you are confident enough, then only you will be able to recall the things. But अगर आपको lack of confidence हो रहा है इस टाइम पे, that is a negative thing. इस टाइम पे तो जितना भी आपने पढ़ लिया है, like whether you studied less or high, doesn't matter. This at this moment, ये matter नहीं करता। इस टाइम पे matter करता है कि कितना आप comfortable feel कर रहे हो examination room में, कितना आप confident feel कर रहे हो। And that's why I'm saying go with the full of energy, full of confidence. Yes, 80% से ज़्यादा रहेगा बच्चों. Cut off will be surely more than 80%. तो चलिए, let's start this particular session, guys. शुरू में energy is high and we are going to start with questions. Later stage पे, like after discussing those 20-30 questions या 40 questions complete करने के बाद, then I will interact with all of you and we will discuss. Like if you are having any general query, then I will take that query also. But this time, let's start with the question answer session. Okay. So let me put here question number one in front of you guys. It's my request to all of you guys, please try each and every question. कुछ क्वेश्चन होंगे जो बहुत डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन होंगे, एंड सम क्वेश्चन पे थोड़ा सा आपको दिमाग लगाना पड़ेगा, यू नीड टू सोल्व. ओके, बट मोस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन इन दिस एग्जामिनेशन यू आर गोइंग टू फाइंड डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन ओनली. आई ऑब्जर्व लाइक आई एनालाइज देयर प्रीवियस ईयर पेपर ऑल्सो, एंड दैट वॉज वेरी ईजी. बिल्कुल डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन होंगे, बट यस, यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट, यू कैन से 20-20%, क्लोज टू 20%, सम काइंड ऑफ मॉडरेट लेवल क्वेश्चन. ओके, चलिए, सो दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. ए स्टेट, ओके, लाइट इज वेरी हाई, लेट मी डिक्रीज द ब्राइटनेस. ओके, आई थिंक नाउ इट इज फाइन. यस, नाउ इट इज फाइन गाइस, ब्राइटनेस अभी ठीक है. यस, आई थिंक नाउ द ब्राइटनेस इज फाइन. Okay, so first question, a state where all phases of water simultaneously coexist. Tino ke tino phases kahan pe exist karte hain guys? Ye exist karte hain triple point pe. And what is triple point for water? Triple point for water is 0.01 degrees Celsius. Okay, aur isko hum bolte hain 273.16 Kelvin. Okay, what is triple point pressure? Triple point pressure for water is 611 Pascal or 0.611 kilopascal. Okay, so you need to remember, triple point is a point where all three phases of a particular substance coexist. Clarity is poor. Okay, let me check what is the problem. चलो मैं brightness थोड़ा सा कम कर देता हूँ screen का. Is it fine now, guys? I think now it is fine. Yes. Now I think it is fine. Okay, good. चलिए, व्हाट इज क्रिटिकल पॉइंट गाइस? क्रिटिकल पॉइंट क्या होता है? क्रिटिकल पॉइंट इज अ पॉइंट वेयर इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू सेग्रीगेट लिक्विड एंड वेपर फेजेस. एट क्रिटिकल पॉइंट लेटेंट हीट विल बिकम जीरो एंड एट क्रिटिकल पॉइंट द डेंसिटीज ऑफ लिक्विड एंड वेपर बिकम सेम. ओके, इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू सेग्रीगेट. It is very difficult to actually segregate between liquid and vapor. Their specific volume, their densities will become same. Okay, and liquid directly flashes into vapor without undergoing into that phase change. Wet region. So, कोई wet region नहीं होगा at critical point. Beyond critical point, latent heat will become zero. Okay, so this is the point where all three phases are not going to exist. At triple point, the all three phases are going to exist, and each and every substance is having unique triple point. For water, you need to remember this data. चलिए, next question. In front of you, second question: if a Carnot engine rejects 1/4 of its heat from to the reservoir, a Carnot reservoir is rejecting 1/4 of its heat. देखो, numerical अगर आएंगे भी very बहुत simple आएंगे, इस तरह का आएगा, तो don't worry about numerical. आपको कोई calculator नहीं उठाना पड़ेगा. Very simple question you are going to face. Carnot engine है, देखो 1/4 reject कर रहा है. Very simply you can think, sir, if it is rejecting 1/4, how much it is utilizing, how much it is producing work? 3/4. Are you getting? 1/4 it is rejecting out of whatever heat it is getting. 1/4 it is rejecting. 3/4 it is utilizing. Means how much is the work produced? 3/4 of the heat which is that engine is getting. Means the efficiency is 3/4, means 75%. So without solving, you can answer this question. Okay, sir, efficiency is 0.75 or 75%. Okay. 75% is the efficiency for this question, guys. इस तरह के question पे बिल्कुल सोचना है and you need to answer quickly. Let us move to the next question, guys. Question number third. A Carnot engine operates between temperature 1000 Kelvin and 400 Kelvin. There is a Carnot engine which is operating between 1000 Kelvin and 400 Kelvin. Okay. The heat rejected to the first Carnot engine. Heat rejected by the first Carnot engine is utilized by the second Carnot engine. The heat rejected by the first is utilized by the second Carnot engine. Okay, whose sink temperature is 200? So this is Carnot 1, heat engine 1. This is Carnot heat engine 1. This is Carnot heat engine 2. Okay, and whatever heat this first is rejecting, that is utilized by the 2. What is asking you? If the net heat absorbed by the first Carnot engine is this, means this is 200 megajoule. The net heat absorbed by the engine 1 is 200 megajoule. Then what is the heat rejected by the second engine? What is this? Heat rejected by the second engine. Very simple question, guys. In seconds, you can answer this question. बच्चों, मेरे पास जो brightness है वो बिल्कुल minimum है. अभी देखो, आप देख, you can check the level. देखो. You can check the level here. This is minimum. अब इससे कम नहीं हो सकता. Okay. Later stage we will check what is the problem. चलिए. So guys, the efficiency of this Carnot engine is what? 60%. How you can say? Sir, here the temperature is 1000. Here the temperature is 400. Means the efficiency of this engine is 60%. So out of that, 60% it is utilizing. Okay. And 40% it is rejecting. So whatever heat this engine is getting, out of that 40% it is rejecting. So 0.4 Q1. 0.4 Q1 it is rejecting. Are you getting the idea, guys? So what is the efficiency of first engine? Efficiency of first engine is 60%, because here the temperature is 400, here the temperature is 1000. You can easily find out that efficiency. So 60% means the work produced is what? The work produced is 0.6 Q1 and the heat rejection is 0.4 Q1. Okay, and that entire heat is going into the heat engine 2, which is having efficiency 50%. Iska efficiency kitna hai bachcho? 50%. How you can say that? 1 minus 200 by 400. So that idea you need to have. So it is having efficiency 50%. So out of what heat it is getting, 50% it is converting into work. Okay. And 50% it is rejecting. So the heat rejected by the engine 2 is nothing but 0.2 Q1. 20% of the Q1. What do you, what is means? 200 multiply by 0.2. What you will get, guys? 200 multiply by 0.2. So what you will get? You will get 40 megajoule. So answer is what? Answer for this question is option A is the right answer. Option A kya ho jayega bachcho? This will be the right answer for this question. So both quickly aapko samajhna hai. There is no need to solve this. Only by observing the temperature, you need to answer. Sir, here 1000, here 700. What is the efficiency? 30%. Here 1000, here 600. What is the efficiency? 40%. here 1000, here 0. Efficiency kitna ho jayega? That will become 100%. That is not possible because we cannot maintain 0 Kelvin. 0 Kelvin is impossible to attain. Okay. So if it is impossible to attain, it is not possible to reject heat at 0 Kelvin. Okay. So efficiency is what? 60%. So this is what heat rejection is 40%. So 40% is going. This engine is having efficiency 50%. So out of this 0.4, 0.2 it is converting into work. 0.2 it is rejecting. So the heat rejection by the second engine is 0.2 of the Q1. So if you will multiply this with 0.2, you will get this answer, 40 megajoule. I hope you all got the answer. Clarity ka issue kyun aa raha hai? I don't know. ओके अभी ठीक है बच्चों, ओके लेट अस चेक यस जस्ट ए मिनट गाइस, गुरुप्रताप जी एक सर को हेलो सर, इसमें तो ठीक आ रहा है लेकिन इसमें जो है ना क्वालिटी उसमें ठीक आ रहा है, इसमें ठीक आ रहा है, बच्चे ही करें ना, yes, obviously guys, Carnot efficiency based depends on the temperature limits only. It is independent of the working fluid. Okay. More is the temperature limit, more will be the efficiency of Carnot engine. We are correcting, guys. We are trying to, you can say, modify this clarity. Don't worry. बच्चों को देखें, कुछ नहीं देखें, इसमें तो बिल्कुल ठीक है. Is it fine now, guys? Please confirm. अभी कुछ ठीक है clarity? डल हो गया काफी, ब्राइटनेस कह रहे हैं, ब्राइटनेस बढ़ाओ. यस ओबवियसली खालिद, व्हाई यू आर हैविंग कंफ्यूजन? Carnot efficiency depends on the temperature limit only. If you know the temperature limit, easily you can evaluate the efficiency of Carnot engine. Okay, let me write it here, the expression, if you are having any confusion. You know, Carnot engine efficiency, or what you can say, reversible efficiency of a heat engine, or maximum efficiency of a heat engine, or what you can say, Carnot efficiency of heat engine, it is nothing but 1 minus T lower by T higher. Okay, so Carnot efficiency depends on temperature limit only. If you know the temperature limit, you can easily find out the efficiency of Carnot heat engine or reversible heat engine. Carnot engine is a reversible engine because when you are adding heat and rejecting heat, what like you are adding heat and rejecting heat at constant temperature. So change in entropy of the system is equal to the change in entropy of the surrounding, and there is no entropy generation in that process, in that cycle. Yes, Carnot efficiency is a function of temperature only. Carnot efficiency is a function of temperature only. I think, guys, now the clarity is fine. Okay, what I can feel this time, chaliye. So let us now move to the next question, guys. Question number 4. The latent heat of steam at pressure greater than atmospheric pressure. The latent heat of steam at a pressure greater than atmospheric pressure. In comparison to the latent heat at atmospheric pressure. What you will answer, guys? Very simple question in front of you. The latent heat of steam at pressure greater than atmospheric pressure. You know, guys, if you will increase the pressure, like, you know, this is the saturation curve. This is your critical point. Okay. And as these are the constant pressure lines. Suppose if I draw here the temperature versus entropy diagram. Okay. So as the pressure increases, what you can say? The latent heat decreases. As the pressure increases, latent heat what decreases? Okay. And at critical point, latent heat will become zero. So what is the answer, guys, for this question? The right answer is, at the latent heat of steam at a pressure greater than atmospheric pressure, it will be less. Okay. Latent heat will be less as compared to the latent heat at atmospheric pressure. Very good. Very good, guys. Chaliye. Let us now move to the next question, guys. Question number 5. Comparatively easy question. The mean effective pressure obtained from the engine indicator diagram. What is indicator diagram? The pressure volume diagram is known as indicator diagram. The PV diagram is known as indicator diagram. Okay, let me draw it for Otto cycle. Constant volume heat addition, constant volume heat rejection, and remaining two processes are isentropic. This is the Otto cycle 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this particular diagram, okay, indicator diagram, PV diagram. So the mean effective pressure is nothing but it is the average pressure. Okay, it is the average pressure. Note the maximum pressure, note the minimum pressure, note the instantaneous pressure. It is the average pressure. What is mean effective pressure, guys? Mean effective pressure, kya hota hai? It is W net divided by swept volume. Okay. Mean effective pressure is a hypothetical pressure which is going to give us the equal amount of work. Okay, if we'll assume the engine is working on that constant mean effective pressure. So it is a constant pressure, hypothetical pressure. Okay, it is not a real pressure, but hypothetical constant pressure which is going to give us equal amount of work. Okay, so mean effective pressure equal to W net divided by swept volume. Okay, so average pressure hota hai. Option D is the right answer for this. Let us move to next question, guys. Question number 6. What happens to the specific volume of water when it is heated at 0 degree Celsius? What happens to the specific volume of water? Specific volume of water pe kya farak padega? Specific volume. What is specific volume, guys? It is nothing but the reverse of density. Reciprocal of density is known as specific volume. Okay. And you know, density of water is maximum. Density of water is equal to 1000 kg per meter cube at 4 degree Celsius. Okay, so density of water is maximum at 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, and you know, density, water is having a unique nature. Okay, for most of the substances, density increases with the decrease in temperature. For most of the substances, guys, as the temperature decreases, density increases. Okay, why? Because they compress actually. Ye kya hota hai? Compress karte hain. Most of the substances, they compresses with the decrease in temperature and their density increases. But water is having unique nature. For water ke liye, as the temperature decreases, its density what? Density decreases. That is the reason density of ice is less than density of water. And that is the reason ice floats over water. So ice hota hai, ice kya karta? Ice float karta water ke surface pe. Why? Because density of ice at 0 degree Celsius, suppose you are having ice at 0 degree Celsius, you are having water at 0 degree Celsius. So which one will have more density? The water at 0 degree Celsius will have more density. That's why the ice floats over the surface of water, liquid water. Okay. So for water, because as you are heating it from 0 degree Celsius, so its density is going to increase. Because 0 degree Celsius, as you will heat, for most of the substances, as temperature increases, density decreases. For most of the substances. This is for most of the substances. Most substances. Okay, but for water, as the temperature increases, density also increases. Why? Because density is maximum at 4 degrees Celsius. So that's why initially density is going to increase. So specific volume kya karega? First decreases karega, and then the specific volume is going to increase. He is not asking you about the density, he is asking you about the specific volume. Yes, anomalous behavior of water. Yes, that is known as anomalous behavior of water. And that is the reason, like on PT curve, if you will draw, you will have a negative slope for water. On PT diagram, you will have an active slope for the which curve? For the fusion curve. Okay, fusion curve of the water having negative slope on PT diagram. For other substances, you will have positive slope. Okay, I hope you able to recall that PT curve for water. Okay, so the right answer for this question is option D. किसी भी बच्चे ने आंसर नहीं किया बच्चों, what you are doing? Try to answer these type of simple question. Option D is the right answer. Why? Because density बढ़ेगी, तो initially the specific volume is what? It is a reverse of density. So initially the specific volume is going to decrease and then again it will start increasing. So D is the right answer for this question. Yes, yes. Fusion curve. बिल्कुल बिल्कुल सही सोच रहे हो आप. Fusion curve. Something like this. If I will draw it here, PT, pressure temperature line, you will have a curve something like this. ये जो curve होती है आपकी कुछ ऐसा, this is the curve for water. ये जो curve होती है, this is the curve for water. Okay, this is your solid, this is vapor. Okay, this is liquid, this is also liquid. Okay, what is the difference? This is the fusion curve for water. Fusion curve for water. Okay, and as you can observe on PT curve, it is having negative slope. PT curve pe iska slope kya hai? Negative hai. This point is a critical point. Isi ke hum kya bolte hain? This is a critical point. This is the triple point. Okay, and at triple point, all three phases are going to coexist. Triple point pe kya karenge? Sare ke sare phases kya karenge? Coexist karenge. So this line is having negative slope. Whereas this particular line is what? Fusion curve for most other substances. Okay. Fusion curve for most other substances. This is solid to vapor sublimation curve. This is your fusion curve and this is your vaporization curve. Liquid to vapor is a vaporization curve. Chaliye. Next question, guys, in front of you. Which of the following is impossible for a particular cycle? You heard about Clausius inequality. Cyclic integration dq by t is always less than equal to zero. Cyclic integration dq by t is always less than equal to zero. Yes. Okay. So this is equal to zero for a reversible cycle. dq by t equal to zero for reversible. Okay. dq by t less than zero for what? Irreversible. Okay. And cyclic integration dq by t greater than zero is impossible. This is impossible. Abhi se ek related question hai. Let me discuss that with you. Why it is impossible? Why cyclic integration dq by t is impossible? Okay. So let me show it here. Let's suppose there is an engine, okay, which is getting some heat Q1 from a some kind of source, a T1, and you are rejecting heat Q2. Okay, this is a reversible engine. Reversible engine taking heat Q1 from a source at T1. Okay, source kya hai aapka T1 pe hai. Okay, and it is rejecting heat Q2 to a source sink at T2. So what is the entropy, cyclic entropy change? Because if this is a system, so in a complete cycle, entropy change of the this particular system will be zero, because in a complete cycle, the change in any property will be zero, because entropy is a property. So for this system will be zero. What is the entropy change of surrounding? It will be what? Q1 by T1. Okay. Isko hum kya bolenge? Q1 by T1. Okay. And this is what? Minus plus this is Q2 by T2. Yes or no? This is Q1 by T1. This is Q2 by T2. So this is the net entropy change of the surrounding. Okay. And as you know, this is what? This is nothing but this is entropy generation. Isi ko to hum entropy generation bolenge. For example. Okay. So entropy change of the system plus surrounding. System ka change nahi hoga in a complete cycle. Surrounding ka kya hoga? This. Okay. And always, you know, in a real process, there must be entropy generation. So ye term kya hona chahiye? This term will always be positive. Ye term kya hogi? This will be always positive. Okay. Ye term hamesha positive hogi. And if this term is positive, what you can say? How you can write cyclic integration dq by t? You can write it as q1 by t1. Okay. Kisi engine mein aap heat add kar rahe ho. Suppose this is a cyclic integration dq by t. This you are writing for a system. If you are adding it Q1 into the system, heat added is positive. So Q1 by T1 minus Q2 by T2. Okay. This can never be greater than zero. Greater than zero nahi ho sakta. Okay. Agar ye greater than zero jayega, so what it means? It means this quantity is more than this. Okay. This quantity is more than this. This is not possible. What it means? It means an engine is getting some kind of X amount of energy and it is rejecting entropy. This is entropy in and entropy out. It is rejecting entropy Y and Y is less than X. This is not possible. This is not possible, guys. Why? Because there must be entropy generation. You cannot destroy entropy. Okay. There must be entropy generation. Exergy is going to destroy. Exergy destruction will be there in a real process. and entropy is going to generate in a real process. So if you are operating an engine, this Y will always be greater than X. Entropy out from an engine will be always more than what entropy it is getting. Okay, so isko entropy balance se bhi samajh sakte ho, like something like this: entropy in minus entropy out plus entropy generation equal to delta S of the system. Okay, delta S of the system. So in a complete cycle, this will be zero. Okay, what is entropy in? It is equal to Q1 by T1. What is entropy out? Q2 by T2. Okay, plus entropy generation. Okay, that is equal to zero. So what it means? It means entropy generation equal to minus Q1 by T1 plus Q2 by T2. Okay, and for getting this term positive, ye term positive kab hogi bachon? What is this? This is entropy generation. This is always positive. And when you will have this term positive, guys, this term will be positive only when this is more than this. Means Q2 by T2 is more than Q1 by T1. Then only entropy generation will be positive. And when this term is positive, it means we are rejecting more entropy rather than what we are taking. Okay. So in a real process, always engine is going to reject more entropy what it is taking. Are you getting this? And in a reversible case, what will be the case? If engine is taking X, it is rejecting X. Okay, but it is not possible taking X and rejecting less than that. That is not possible. I hope you got the point. So, maine thoda sa aapko concept bataya hai. Remaining, you need to remember this case. This is the general case. Reversible zero, irreversible less than zero, and greater than zero is not possible. Why it is not possible? Because entropy generation will always be positive. Aap entropy ko destroy nahi kar sakte. Okay, I hope you got the point. Chaliye. Let us now move to the next question, guys. Which of the substance is classified as pure substance? Which of the following substance is classified as pure substance, guys? Pure substance kise bolte hain bachon? A substance which is homogeneous in chemical composition and aggregation. Ek aisa substance jiski chemical composition kya hoti hai? Homogeneous hoti hai. That is known as a pure substance. A galat ho jayega bachon. Humid air is not a pure substance. Humid air is not a pure substance. Dry air you can consider as a pure substance. Okay. प्योर सब्सटेंस के लिए व्हाट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट? एक चीज समझ लो, प्योर सब्सटेंस में इट कैन बी ए सिंगल एलिमेंट. लाइक इफ यू आर हैविंग प्योर आयरन, प्योर निकल, प्योर कार्बन, ऑल प्योर सिंगल एलिमेंट्स, दे आर प्योर सब्सटेंस. सिंगल एलिमेंट्स हो सकते हैं या मे बी कंपाउंड हो सकते हैं. सिंगल एलिमेंट्स तो समझ रहे हो ना, व्हाट डू मीन बाय सिंगल एलिमेंट्स? लाइक हीलियम, हाइड्रोजन, कार्बन, आयरन, ओके, निकल, ऑल सिंगल सब्सटेंसेस, सिंगल एलिमेंट, दे आर प्योर सब्सटेंसेस. एंड देयर कंपाउंड ऑल्सो, they are can be considered as a pure substance as long as their chemical composition is uniform throughout, like CO2, okay, water, they are also known as a pure substance. So if you are having H2O, like if you will boil water, is it possible ki oxygen will first separate it out and hydrogen will then separate it out? Is it possible? No. If you are having a pure substance, the pure substance is having unique boiling point. It is not like that ki those compounds, they are separately, they are going to boil. It is not like that. But suppose if you will take a mixture of sand and water, and if you will start boiling the water, what will happen? The water will be separated out first, and sand will be later. You can say it will be, you will be able to find out that in the, what you can say, bottom of the container, because they are having different boiling point. So if you are having a pure substance must have a unique boiling point. Okay, jaise CO2 hai, water hai, and any other substance, like suppose if you take air, okay, dry air ko agar hum mante hain, so those gases you are having, those are very difficult to segregate physically. Physically you cannot segregate those gases. But if you take humid air, the water vapor present in the air, can you separate it very easily? If you will pass the humid air over a cooling coil, and if the cooling coil temperature is below the DPT, dew point temperature, then surely you will be able to remove the water vapor present in the air. Yes, water vapor present in the air, we will be easily able to remove. Why? Because they are having different boiling points. Unka boiling point kya hai? Different hai. And if their boiling point is different, easily you will be able to separate them. Okay. So if pure substance, it may be single element, it may be compounds, as long as chemical composition is same. So sugar in water is also not a pure substance. Why? Because if you take sugar in water, then also you will be easily able to segregate those sugar in water by boiling, because they are having different boiling points. Pure substance kab hoga? When that substance is having unique single boiling point. I hope you got the idea. So this is soil. Soil may be bahut sare substances honge, and they will have different properties, different boiling points. Humid air is also not a pure substance. Sand in water is also not a pure substance. Baking soda is a pure substance. बेकिंग सोडा क्या हो जाएगा आपका, इट इज अ प्योर सब्सटेंस गाइस, सो यू कैन से अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट डू मीन बाय प्योर सब्सटेंस, आर यू गेटिंग द आइडिया गाइस, चलिए ओके, सो शुगर इन वाटर, सैंड इन वाटर, दीज आर दी नॉट ए प्योर सब्सटेंस, ओके, मिक्सचर आप बोल सकते हो, सैंड इन वाटर इज ए हेट्रोजीनियस मिक्सचर, शुगर इन वाटर इज ए होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर, बस इतना फर्क है, शुगर को अगर पानी में ऐड करोगे तो यू विल गेट ए होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर, सैंड इन वाटर इज ए हेट्रोजीनियस मिक्सचर, बट बोथ आर नॉट प्योर सब्सटेंसेस, ओके, चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, ए रिवर्सिबल इंजन ऑपरेट्स बिटवीन टेम्परेचर 1200 एंड 600 केल्विन, रिजेक्ट्स 30% ऑफ द हीट, this engine will comes under which category, this engine will come under which category, try to answer guys very quickly, yes Sunil, your concept is also right, fine, the composition is different, okay, so water in air is not everywhere same, so it is not homogeneous in chemical composition, but that can confuse you, why, like suppose if you take sugar in water and if you thoroughly mix that sugar in water, like then also you will have a homogeneous mixture, but that is also not a pure substance, why, because that easily you will be able to separate that sugar in water, physical ya usko ya boiling karke usko separate kar sakte, but if you are having a pure substance, then if you will boil, the entire substance is going to boil. It is not like that ki carbon will boil first and then oxygen will boil second. And easily by boiling carbon dioxide, you will be able to segregate carbon and oxygen. It is not like that. If you are having carbon dioxide, it is having what? A unique single boiling point. Okay. Chaliye. So, a engine, what is the efficiency of this engine, guys? The engine which is given to us, it is having efficiency 50%. How we can say? Sir, this is the temperature 600, this is the temperature 1200. So, efficiency of the given engine is 50%. And he's saying, this is the reversible efficiency. This is the reversible efficiency of the given engine. The reversible efficiency of the given engine is 50%. And he, the particular inventor is claiming, ki he is rejecting 30%. If he is rejecting 30%, how much he is producing for 70%? Means, what is the efficiency claimed? Efficiency claimed. Okay. Efficiency claimed is 70%. Are you getting the idea? 30% it is rejecting means the efficiency claimed by the inventor is 70%, whereas reversible efficiency is for 50%. Is it possible? It is not possible. Always, reversible cycle efficiency will be more than the actual cycle efficiency. So, this engine will came out under impossible category. Isko hum kisme bolenge? Impossible. This engine is not possible. This is impossible. That's why we will go with option D, none of these. Yes, good. Very good, guys. Okay. Chaliye. Next question in front of you. What is the drop-in enthalpy of a steam whistle which is perfectly insulated and does not work, has an exit velocity of steam at in meter per second? What is asking you? What is the drop-in enthalpy? What is the drop-in enthalpy for a steam whistle which is perfectly insulated? So, there is no heat transfer. कोई हीट ट्रांसफर नहीं होगा ओके आप एक्सपेंशन कर रहे हो इसमें देयर इज नो वर्क ट्रांसफर आल्सो आपसे क्या बोल रहा है चेंज इन एंथैल्पी यस तो यस द ड्रॉप इन एंथैल्पी फॉर अ स्टीम विसल इज डज नॉट वर्क द एग्जिट वेलोसिटी ऑफ द ट्रिम व्हाट इज द ड्रॉप इन एंथैल्पी does not work has an exit velocity do cheeze puch li isne chalo let us try to develop some kind of relationship so let us consider this process as a steady process so what you can write h1 plus v1 square by 2 plus zz1 plus q equal to h2 plus c2 square by 2 plus zz2 plus wcv okay so in this case there is no work transfer okay we can neglect the potential energy changes potential energy changes we can neglect okay heat transfer there is no heat transfer okay inlet velocity also we can assume zero nozzle hai to inlet velocity we can assume okay inlet velocity is what it is like zero exit velocity will be somewhat higher than that so h1 minus h2 is a drop in enthalpy and that is equal to c2 square by 2 this is equal to c2 square by 2 to mere khayal se kuch data isme kuch miss ho gaya hai what is a drop in enthalpy for a steam whistle which is perfectly insulated and does not work has an exit velocity. So, two things can be asked. Two things he cannot ask you two things. So, something is missing. I think something is missing in this question. Okay, chaliye. So if you know the drop-in enthalpy, then easily you can find out this. But you have to keep in mind one thing. let me here give you drop enthalpy as suppose 1000 kilojoule per kg. So suppose this is 1000 kilojoule. So this is C2 square by, aapko yahan pe 2000 likhna padega. This you need to remember. Okay. Here generally we write it something like this, but if you are putting the drop in enthalpy in kilojoule per kg, so here you need to use 2000. Why? Because here if you are using units kilojoule per kg, then here also you need to convert this also in kilojoule per kg. हाँ, एग्जिट वेलोसिटी कुछ ना कुछ तो उसको चाहिए. यहां पे अगर एग्जिट वेलोसिटी पूछेगा तो ड्रॉप इन एंथैल्पी आपको पता होना चाहिए. ओके, ड्रॉप इन एंथैल्पी आपको पता होना चाहिए. तो सम डेटा इज मिसिंग इन दिस क्वेश्चन. चलिए, द इंटरनल एनर्जी ऑफ ए गैस ओबेइंग वंडर वाल्स इक्वेशन. इंटरनल एनर्जी ऑफ ए गैस ओबेइंग वंडर वाल इक्वेशन. This is the wonder wall equation, guys. You know, this we use for a real gas. Okay, this is your ideal gas equation. PV equal to MRT. Okay, or PV equal to NR bar T. Okay, this is known as ideal gas equation. Or isi bolte hum PVT relationship. Pressure volume temperature relationship for. This is the pressure volume temperature relationship for a ideal gas. Okay, Pradeep, charger diyo mere bag mein se, laptop ka. And this is the PVT relationship for a real gas. So what do you answer, guys? Temperature, internal energy is asking you internal energy, U. Yes, very good. So internal energy is a function of kiska hota hai? Temperature and specific volume. You can write it here also, du. Like if you will take total derivative, you can write it here, del U by del T at constant V dT, okay, plus del U by del V, okay, at constant T dV. Something like this you can write, okay. And dU, you can write it as CV dT plus del U by del V at constant T dV. So this you need to remember, okay. This you need to remember. This is the change in internal energy for a real gas. CVDT plus this term we are having for ideal gas. So this term, like if you, any person will ask you or you will face some question, what is del U by del V for T at constant temperature for a ideal gas? So for a ideal gas, del U by del V at constant T, this will be what? This will be zero for ideal gas. Okay, for a ideal gas, because for a ideal gas, du equal to CVDT. Okay, similarly you can write for enthalpy also. Aap enthalpy ke liye bhi likh sakte ho, enthalpy temperature pressure. So you can write it as dh equal to del U by del T at constant P dT, sorry, del H. Okay, so this will be del H by del T at constant P dT plus del H by del P at constant T dP. Okay, this you can write it for enthalpy also. So dh equal to cp dt plus del h by del p at constant t dp. These are for real gases, guys. Kiske liye? Real gases ke liye. This is for real gas change in enthalpy. This is also the change in internal energy for a real gas. Okay, but for ideal gas, du equal to cv dt and dh equal to cp dt. These are for ideal gases. Ideal gases. Okay, but there is no such ideal gas in real. All gases are what? They are real gases only. But we assume, okay, generally, like if you are having a gas, okay, at a very low pressure and high temperature, we can consider it as a ideal gas. Okay, compressibility factor hum maan ke chalte hain. So if the compressibility factor is close to one, then we treat that gas as a ideal gas. So kai baar ek question aapse puch leta hai wo exam mein. Like if gas is close to the critical point, its behavior will be close to the ideal gas behavior or not. So kuch bachche soch rahe the ki critical point hai. So critical point to bahut high temperature hoga, then gas will behave as a ideal gas. No, guys, at the critical point, the deviation, the Z will be what you can say very low. What you can say, the compressibility factor hoga jo bahut low hoga, and the deviation from the ideal gas will be very high. So a gas is not going to behave as a ideal gas close to the critical point. Rather, it is, the behavior will be far away from the ideal gas behavior. Gas kahan pe behave karte hai? In general, we say, in general, if compressibility factor is one, okay, to gas kya hota hai? Gas behaves as a ideal gas. Kai baar aapse compressibility factor bhi pooch leta hai. What is compressibility factor for this van der Waals gas? Van der Waals gas ke liye, what is the compressibility factor? I will wait for your comment. So please try to answer. What is the compressibility factor for van der Waals gas? To kuch kai baar direct question aapko mil jata hai. चलिए सो इस क्वेश्चन को मैं आंसर कर देता हूं. टेम्परेचर एंड स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम, सी इज द राइट आंसर. सी विल बी द राइट आंसर फॉर दिस. टेम्परेचर प्रेशर होगा किसके लिए? एंथैल्पी के लिए. फॉर एंथैल्पी यू कैन गो विद द टेम्परेचर प्रेशर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, अकॉर्डिंग टू डेल्टन्स लॉ ऑब्वियसली लेस देन वन होगा. सुनील, वंडरवॉल्स गैस के लिए, वंडरवॉल इज नॉट ए रियल गैस. ओके, तो इट विल बी लेस देन वन. चलिए, सो अकॉर्डिंग टू डेल्टन्स लॉ द टोटल प्रेशर ऑफ मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेस इज इक्वल टू. डेल्टन्स लॉ क्या कहता है? इफ यू आर हैविंग ए गैस एट सम प्रेशर, ओके, टोटल प्रेशर, टेम्परेचर, वॉल्यूम, इफ यू आर हैविंग ए गैस विच इज हैविंग डिफरेंट यू कैन से मिक्सचर्स, इफ यू आर हैविंग ए होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर ऑफ आइडियल गैसेस, इफ यू आर हैविंग ए होमोजीनियस, इसे मैं क्या बोल रहा हूं, होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर ऑफ आइडियल गैसेस. अगर आपके पास होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर ऑफ आइडियल गैसेस होता है तो जो टोटल प्रेशर होता है गैस का, टोटल प्रेशर, इसी को मैं पी लिख रहा हूं. टोटल प्रेशर और पी ऑफ ए गैस इज इक्वल टू द सम ऑफ पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल गैसेस, P1, P2, P3, सो ऑन. The total pressure of a gas is equal to the sum of the partial pressure of the individual gases. And how you will get the partial pressure, guys? Agar us gas ko individually you will consider, if a gas, like any gas one, like suppose, individually if you will consider at what? Same volume and same temperature. So the pressure occupied by this gas is P1. So if this is a gas, homogeneous mixture of ideal gases, and this gas is at a total pressure P, temperature T, volume V. So individually, if you take that gas at the same volume and temperature, what pressure that gas occupies, that is known as partial pressure of that gas. Okay. So yahan pe is gas ka pressure kya hoga? P1. Similarly, if you will take gas 2, so gas 2 is going to occupy pressure 2, if you will take it, this also at a same volume and temperature. So if you will add all these total, like P1, P2, P3, you will get the total pressure. So this is known as Dalton's law of partial pressure. And this is applicable to what? Homogeneous mixture of ideal gases. Okay, so right answer for this question is what? Option C is the right answer. Option C kya ho jayega bachon? This will be the right answer for this question. Very good. Chaliye. Next question in front of you. When a liquid boils at constant pressure, the following parameter increases. When a liquid boils at constant pressure पे जब आप उसको boil करते हो, the following parameter increases. क्या बढ़ता है बच्चों? When a liquid boils at constant pressure, what increases? Constant pressure पे जब हम liquid को boil करते हैं तो क्या बढ़ता है? सुनील कोई बात नहीं, अभी तो इसके बारे में सोचने का फायदा नहीं है. इफ यू मिस द फॉर्म देन दिस टाइम यू नीड नॉट टू वरी. इफ ए लिक्विड इज बॉइलिंग एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर, व्हाट इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज, क्या बढ़ेगा? इफ ए लिक्विड इज बॉइलिंग एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर, व्हाट इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. आई एम वेटिंग फॉर योर रिस्पॉन्स गाइज. 39 स्टूडेंट्स आर वॉचिंग एंड ओनली 3-4 आर रिस्पॉन्डिंग. व्हाट अदर्स आर डूइंग? ऑल आर गोइंग विद ऑप्शन बी. Okay, Narayan, Rohit, Sunil, you all are saying B. But guys, B is the wrong answer. Why? Dekho, constant pressure pe agar aap heat kar rahe ho kisi ko. If you are heating constant pressure, this is a constant pressure line. You are converting saturated liquid. This is what? Saturated liquid. Okay. This is saturated vapor. Saturated liquid ko saturated vapor mein convert karoge. Toh in boiling, प्रेशर रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट, प्रेशर कॉन्स्टेंट रहता है बॉइलिंग में, टेम्परेचर भी कॉन्स्टेंट रहता है. जो भी लेटेंट हीट है एट दैट पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर प्रेशर, दैट विल ऑल्सो कॉन्स्टेंट. ये भी तो कॉन्स्टेंट रहेगा बिकॉज एट ए बॉइलिंग वट लेटेंट हीट इज ए सब्सटेंस इज गोइंग टू टेक, दैट विल ऑल्सो बी कॉन्स्टेंट. बट एंट्रोपी इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. एंट्रोपी बढ़ेगी. वाई? बिकॉज चेंज इन एंट्रोपी इन द फेज चेंज प्रोसेस, दैट इज इक्वल टू HFG डिवाइड बाई टी सेचुरेशन. This is a change in entropy in a phase change process. So, jaldi nahi karni hai, guys. Don't be in hurry. Please read the entire question. Pura question padh ke answer karna hai, bachon. Okay. So entropy is going to increase. When you are boiling a particular substance, so both pressure temperature remains constant. Boiling mein pressure temperature constant rehta hai, and at that particular temperature pressure, latent heat will also be constant. Latent heat decreases with the increase in pressure. Pressure badhaoge to latent heat will decrease. But he has not mentioned about pressure. Pressure is constant. So at a constant pressure, latent heat will also be constant. Are you getting the idea? Okay. 100 degrees Celsius. If you want to boil water at 100 degrees Celsius, okay, and one atmospheric, what is its latent heat of vaporization? That is constant. 230-260 ke aaspaas hum lete hain kilo joule per kg. That is constant. Similarly, latent heat of fusion, that is also constant. 334 kilo joule per kg. Uske aaspaas. Okay. But your entropy is going to increase. And what is entropy? HFG by T saturation. So D is the right answer. Okay, chaliye. Next question. Ideal gas at 27 degrees Celsius is heated at constant pressure till its volume become 3 times. What is the temperature of the gas? What is the temperature of the bilkul CSL level ke question hai bachu. I am not discussing any question like engineering services ka previous year. Okay, so all are like matching with the CSL level only because I observed their previous year papers. Okay, so bilkul easy question hai. Inko to aapko tips pe hone chahiye question aapke. बिल्कुल सही बच्चों, 627 इज द राइट आंसर. आइडियल गैस है, व्हाट इज द प्रोसेस? कांस्टेंट प्रेशर. तो V by T इक्वल टू कांस्टेंट, और व्हाट यू कैन से V1 by T1 इक्वल टू V2 by T2. सो V2 इज बिकमिंग 3 times, तो इसको मैं लिख सकता हूं V इक्वल टू 3V इक्वल टू T1. T1 इज व्हाट? 300. ओके, सो दिस इज योर T2. तो ये कट जाएगा आपका. सो T2 विल बी व्हाट? 900 केल्विन. ओके, तो इसी को मैं लिख सकता हूं कितना? 627 डिग्री सेल्सियस. तो 900 मत आंसर कर देना, 900 डिग्री सेल्सियस दिया है बच्चों. He has not given you 900 केल्विन. So from this calculation you will get 900 केल्विन, but there is no option with 900 केल्विन. 627 डिग्री सेल्सियस इज द राइट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ नॉन मेटालिक अमोर्फस सॉलिड. Non-metallic amorphous solid. Last time उसने एक CSL में पूछा था कि conductivity water का कितना होता है. तो conductivity of water is close to 0.505, है ना? इतना होता है, 0.551 के आसपास, 5152 के आसपास watt per meter kelvin. Conductivity इतना होता है. Conductivity of air बहुत कम होता है. It is in the range of 0.025 something watt per meter kelvin. बहुत कम होता है. Conductivity of air is very less as compared to the water. CSL में पूछा गया था conductivity of water. ओके, तो मोस्ट ऑफ द सब्सटेंसेस के लिए, एयर वगैरह के लिए कंडक्टिविटी, गैसेस के लिए कंडक्टिविटी बढ़ता है. सॉलिड के लिए क्या करेगा? इफ इट इज अ मेटल, कंडक्टिविटी डिक्रीजेस विद द इंक्रीज इन टेंपरेचर. एंड फॉर ए नॉन मेटल होगा तो कंडक्टिविटी क्या करता है बच्चों? कंडक्टिविटी इंक्रीजेस विद द इंक्रीज इन टेंपरेचर. टेंपरेचर बढ़ेगा तो कंडक्टिविटी बढ़ेगा, बिकॉज ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट नॉन मेटालिक अमोर्फस सॉलिड. सो नॉन मेटालिक अमोर्फस सॉलिड कंडक्टिविटी इंक्रीजेस विद द इंक्रीज इन टेंपरेचर. But he's saying with the decrease in temperature, obviously it will decrease. So option B is the right answer. B will be the right answer for this question. Okay. Option B is the right answer. Vinod, please check your answer. Vinod, galat ho jayega, increase galat ho jayega. Yes. Decrease is the right answer. So I will write here. Gases ke liye, temperature badhega, conductivity badhegi. Metals, टेम्परेचर बढ़ेगा, कंडक्टिविटी घटेगी. नॉन मेटल्स, टेम्परेचर बढ़ेगा, कंडक्टिविटी बढ़ेगी. लिक्विड्स, टेम्परेचर बढ़ेगा, कंडक्टिविटी घटेगी. व्हाई? दिस इज ड्यू टू डिक्रीज इन डेंसिटी. लिक्विड्स में जैसे जैसे टेम्परेचर बढ़ता है, डेंसिटी डिक्रीज करती है बच्चों. एंड ड्यू टू डिक्रीज इन डेंसिटी लिक्विड क्या करेगा? लिक्विड एक्सपैंड. डेंसिटी बढ़ेगी कब? व्हेन मॉलिक्यूल विल कम आउट, कम क्लोजर टू ईच अदर. अगर मॉलिक्यूल एक दूसरे के आसपास आएंगे तो मॉलिक्यूल इंटरेक्शन विल बी मोर, कंडक्टिविटी विल इंक्रीज. सो फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ द लिक्विड्स टेम्परेचर बढ़ेगा तो कंडक्टिविटी डिक्रीज करेगी. व्हाई? ड्यू टू डिक्रीज इन डेंसिटी. दिस इज ड्यू टू डेंसिटी डिक्रीज. डेंसिटी डिक्रीज करती है, टेम्परेचर बढ़ाते हैं तो डेंसिटी घटती है. डेंसिटी घटती है तो मॉलिक्यूल एक्सपैंड करते हैं, एंड इफ दे एक्सपैंड देयर कंडक्टिविटी डिक्रीजेस. ओके, बट इफ यू राइट इट हियर फॉर वाटर, अगर मैं वाटर लिखूंगा तो वाटर के लिए क्या हो जाएगा? वाटर का टेम्परेचर बढ़ता है ना 0 to 4, तो उसकी डेंसिटी भी बढ़ती है, तो उसका कंडक्टिविटी क्या करेगा? बढ़ेगा. तो वाटर के केस में इनिशियली द कंडक्टिविटी विल इंक्रीज, and then the conductivity will decrease. What is the special one? Okay, I discussed earlier also. So for water, the conductivity initially it is going to increase, then it will decrease. So आपको कुछ ऐसा curve मिलेगा water के लिए अगर आप temperature और conductivity का plot करोगे, कुछ ऐसा. Initially it will increase and then it will decrease. But for most of the liquids, conductivity decreases with the increase in temperature because they expand with the increase in temperature. ठीक है? चलिए. In the figure given below, curve A which will be applicable when thermal conductivity of the material. Curve A किसको applicable होगा बच्चों? Curve A is applicable to what? Increases with increase in temperature, decreases with increase in temperature. In the figure given below, curve A will be applicable when thermal conductivity of the material. Thermal conductivity of a material increases with the increase in temperature, decreases with increase in temperature, is very large, is constant for all temperature. So, ये जो D line है ना, D वाली, ये होता है constant thermal conductivity. Constant K. Straight line आपको कब मिलती है? Constant K. Means dT by dx, that is also constant. Temperature जो आपका gradient होता है, that also will be constant. If the conductivity is constant. ये ऊपर वाली line कब मिलती है? जब कंडक्टिविटी क्या करता है बढ़ता है विद द इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर बिकॉज हेयर बिकॉज इन दिस डायरेक्शन हीट इज गोइंग टू ट्रांसफर अगर आप ये स्लोप है सो दिस इज द टी वन दिस इज टी टू सो हीट इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम टी वन टू टी टू एंड इफ हीट इज ट्रांसफरिंग फ्रॉम टी वन टू टी टू वेयर द टेम्परेचर ग्रेडियंट इज हाई गाइस हेयर यू कैन ऑब्जर्व दिस इज द टेम्परेचर ग्रेडियंट एंड दिस टेम्परेचर ग्रेडियंट इज हाई सो इफ टेम्परेचर सॉरी दिस टेम्परेचर ग्रेडियंट इज वेरी लो डी टी बाई डी एक्स इज वेरी लो ओके ये दोनों रिवर्स होते हैं बच्चों K is inversely proportional to dT by dx. Okay. So if K is high, dT by dx will be low. Okay. So here, because as you can observe, dT by dx is very low, so conductivity is high. So at high temperature, conductivity is high. At low temperature, conductivity is low. Means conductivity increases with the increase in temperature. Option A is the right answer. Option A will be the right answer. Okay. चलिए. Yes, Pradeep sir. हेलो प्रदीप देख इस पे ना कुछ कमेंट आ रहे हैं उसको ब्लॉक कर दो रिमूव कर देना चैनल पे देखा एक बार हाँ वो आपके चलो मैं इधर से कर देता हूँ एक बार मेरे ख्याल से इधर से ही हो जाए ना चलिए ओके गाइस सो फॉर दिस कर्व लोअर कर्व बी कर्व इफ यू विल ऑब्जर्व हेयर द टेम्परेचर ग्रेडियंट इज व्हाट डीटी बाय डीएक्स इज वेरी हाई एंड हेयर डीटी बाय डीएक्स इज वेरी लो मींस एट दिस पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट द कंडक्टिविटी इज हाई एंड हेयर द कंडक्टिविटी इज लो मींस एट हाई टेम्परेचर कंडक्टिविटी इज लो एंड एट लो टेम्परेचर कंडक्टिविटी इज हाई व्हाट इट मींस कंडक्टिविटी इज डिक्रीजिंग विद द increase in temperature and for the upper case conductivity increases with the increase in temperature so for this case curve A because he is asking you for curve A so option A is the right answer okay theek hai bachcho chaliye so next question in front of you guys the door of a running refrigerator inside a room was left open which of the following statement is correct Like if you will open the door of your refrigerator and if you will keep it open for some time, what will happen? अच्छा करण को दोबारा explain कर देता हूँ चलिए. Okay, you know guys, Fourier law of heat conduction. Fourier law of heat conduction, heat transfer by conduction is equal to minus K A dT by dx. Okay, so from this easily you can analyze that this dT by dx is nothing but Q conduction divided by Ka. Okay, that is the reason I have written that this dT by dx is inversely proportional to K. More is the thermal conductivity, lower will be the temperature gradient. So guys, if you will take a substance, something like this, which is having very high conductivity. So if the conductivity is very high, you will have a straight line, conductivity infinite. Okay. So if you are having an infinite conductivity, here the temperature is T1 and here also you will get the temperature close to T1. So you will get a horizontal line. Okay. And as the conductivity decreases, you will have curves, some line, something like this. Okay. So this is the line which is representing maximum dt by dx. dt by dx क्या है? इसका high है. So in this direction you can observe dt by dx is increasing and what you can say, conductivity is decreasing. So if conductivity is high, you will have a horizontal line, dt by dx will be very less. And if conductivity is low, dt by dx will be very high. That first thing you need to know about this. Next, if you will observe this diagram guys, here, अगर आप इसको observe करते हो, you are having a curve, something like this. So this is a straight line and this is a curved one, something like this. So here, if you will observe the temperature versus x, dt by dx. Okay. So dt by dx here, what is dt by dx? So this is dt by dx. At this point, what is dt by dx? This is dt by dx. And at this point, what is dt by dx? This is dt by dx. So when we are moving in this direction, the dt by dx is changing. Means this is a case of variable thermal conductivity. If dt by dx is constant, that is a case of constant thermal conductivity. And if dt by dx is not a constant, that is a case of variable thermal conductivity. Now the second question arises, in variable thermal conductivity, that case is what? Increase in thermal conductivity with the increase in temperature or decrease in thermal conductivity with the increase in temperature. So guys, as you can observe here, because heat is going to transfer from high temperature to low temperature, here dt by dx is very low, so means here conductivity is high. And here the slope is very high, so means here conductivity is low. It means at high temperature conductivity is high and at low temperature conductivity is low. What it means? Conductivity is increasing with the increase in temperature, because at high temperature conductivity is more, at low temperature conductivity is low. So conductivity kya kar raha? It is increasing with the increase in temperature, and for this curve you can write k equal to k naught into 1 plus alpha t, something like this. This relationship you can write k equal to ko into 1 plus alpha t. Okay, so this term will be positive. Temperature increases, conductivity increases. I hope this is now clear to you guys. Chaliye. Next question, the door of a running refrigerator inside a room was left open. Which of the following statement is correct? Yes. To kya answer karoge bachcho iska? If you will open the door of a refrigerator, guys, it is going to reject heat inside the room only. To agar aapne door uska open kar diya, so kisi bhi refrigerator ke liye, you know, rejection is nothing but heat addition plus W in. Okay, whether you are having a heat pump or refrigerator, rejection will be always heat addition plus W in. So if you are keeping the door open of your refrigerator, it is going to take some heat from the room. Ye heat lega, obviously heat addition hoga. But what is it? It is going to reject. It is going to reject QR, and QR will be always QA plus W in. Rejection will be always more than the heat addition. Like if you will take a case of reversible, you can say refrigerator, something like this. Okay, so this is low temperature, this is high temperature. Suppose you are adding heat QA with some work W in. So what is Q rejection? If you apply here first law of thermodynamics, energy in equal to energy out. So rejection will be what? Addition plus W in. Okay, so if you are keeping the door open of your refrigerator, the temperature is going to increase. Why? Because sir, rejection is always more than addition. So room kya karega? It will gradually warm up. Okay, room will gradually warm up. C is the right answer. Very good. C is the right answer, guys, for this question. Let me ask you one more question, guys. If you will put window AC inside your room, agar aap apna window AC ko apne room ke andar rakh dete hain, the temperature is going to increase or decrease? Like if you run that window AC, keeping AC inside your room, again the temperature is going to increase. Why? Because sir, if you are running a AC which is inside the room, it is going to extract heat from the room and it is going to reject heat also inside the room only, and rejection is always more than addition. Rejection equal to addition plus W in. So the net addition of heat will be there inside the room, and due to that the room temperature is going to increase. Fan agar aap chala rahe ho, if you are running a fan, like if I will give you an insulated room, and if you are continuously using a fan inside that room, again the temperature is going to increase. Why? Because whatever electricity we are supplying, the part of that will convert into what? Heat. Okay, because there is a friction inside the various component, and due to that heat, when it will go into the room, again the temperature of room is going to increase. We are able to produce refrigeration only if we'll place evaporator side inside the room and condenser side outside the room. Means from room we are extracting heat and we are rejecting it outside. Okay, then only we will be able to produce the refrigeration. We will be able to drop the temperature inside the room. Okay, chaliye. Next question, for the same compression ratio and heat addition, R same hai, हीट एडिशन सेम है, सो विच विल हैव मोर एफिशिएंसी। बहुत फेमस क्वेश्चन है पीएसयू का, बहुत बार पूछा जाता है। सेम कंप्रेशन रेशियो, सेम हीट एडिशन, विच विल बी मोर एफिशिएंट। ऑलवेज ऑटो साइकिल एफिशिएंसी विल बी मोर देन 12 एंड इट विल बी मोर देन डीजल। Diesel efficiency will be least for the same compression ratio, but that is not the actual case, because in actual case always the auto cycle compression ratio will be far lower than the diesel cycle compression ratio. Diesel cycle compression ratio is in the range of 16 to 20, and sometime you will face some question why the compression ratio of diesel engine is limited. The diesel engine compression ratio is limited due to manufacturing limitation. Like if you will go with very high compression ratio, then the peak temperature, peak pressure inside the engine will increase and the engine will become very bulky. Okay, because for withstand, for you can say, you can say for bearing that very huge high pressure, we need to make the engine more robust. Okay, so due to manufacturing limitation, due to weight of the engine, the compression ratio of diesel engine is restricted in the range of 16 to 20. Why the compression ratio of petrol engine is limited, guys? It is limited because if you will go beyond 10, that can cause pre-ignition of the charge. So knocking tendency in petrol engine increases with high compression ratio. Okay, so in general, for same compression ratio, same heat addition, auto cycle will be more efficient. And in general, always diesel cycle will be more efficient than petrol. Why? Because diesel engine compression ratio is more than the petrol engine compression ratio. Okay, and for the same peak pressure, peak temperature, same peak temperature, peak pressure, then also diesel cycle is more efficient than auto cycle. So auto cycle is efficient only if you will take a case of same compression ratio. So answer kya ho jayega bachcho? Auto cycle is more efficient than diesel cycle. Option A is the right answer. The efficiency of diesel engine with the decrease in cutoff ratio. With the decrease in cutoff ratio, what is the change in the efficiency? Yes, guys. Chaliye. What is the efficiency of diesel engine, guys? Efficiency of diesel engine, we can write it as 1 minus 1 by compression ratio ki power gamma minus 1 into rho, cutoff ratio ki power gamma minus 1 into gamma into rho minus 1. This is the efficiency of diesel engine. Okay, efficiency expression for diesel engine. Jaise hum cutoff ratio ko badhate hain bachcho, heat addition badh jata hai, W net bhi badh jata hai, efficiency ghat jati hai. Remember, if you are increasing the cutoff ratio, if you are increasing, means more fuel you are injecting. This is pressure, this is volume line, and this is your diesel cycle, something like this. One, two, three, four. Okay, so this is your diesel cycle. 1 to 2 isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion, and 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. So if you are increasing the cutoff ratio, what is cutoff ratio? Cutoff ratio is V3 by V2. Okay. So if you want to increase the cutoff ratio, you need to inject more and more fuel. So if you are increasing cutoff ratio, heat addition is going to increase, because here, like if I will take one more case, suppose you increase the cutoff ratio to 3 dash. So this will be the new diesel cycle. Something like this. This will be the new diesel cycle, guys. Okay. So upper one is 4 dash, lower one is what? 4. This is 4. Okay. And this is 4-1. So this is the additional area you are going to get. If you are increasing the cutoff ratio. So with the increase in cutoff ratio, these are going to increase. But efficiency decreases. Why? Because W net is increasing, but at the same time heat addition is also increasing. So what is efficiency? Efficiency is W net by heat addition. Okay, so efficiency is going to decrease with the increase in cutoff ratio. But he is asking you, with the decrease in cutoff ratio, agar cutoff ratio ko decrease karoge, then efficiency will increase. So option A is the right answer for this question. Okay, option A will be the right answer. Why you are going with D, guys? Jayesh, D galat ho jayega. First increases, then decreases. No, this is wrong. Efficiency, let me write it here. Efficiency diesel is directly proportional to R, directly proportional to compression ratio, directly proportional to gamma, means gamma can be directly proportional, like compression ratio can be directly proportional, and it is inversely proportional to cutoff ratio. As you will increase the R, efficiency increases. As you will increase the gamma, gamma means if you will use some kind of monatomic gases like helium, hydrogen, those are having gamma more than the carbon dioxide. Okay, your exhaust gases, they are having gamma close to 1.33. For air, gamma is 1.4, and for monatomic gases, gamma is 1.67. So if you increase the gamma adiabatic index, the efficiency increases. If you increase the compression ratio, efficiency increases. If you increase the cutoff ratio, efficiency is going to decrease. Okay, yes, good. Chaliye. Next question, guys, in front of you. During a process on the closed system, internal energy increases by twice the units than the heat added to it. Internal energy increases by twice. Then what is the heat added? Okay, during a process on the closed system, what is a closed system? Closed system, we can write first law something like this, dq equal to du plus dw. This is first law of thermodynamics for a closed system. What is saying? During a process on the closed system, internal energy increases two times of the heat which you are adding. Okay, so suppose this is dq, this is what, this is two times of the heat, you can write plus dw. It means what? Ye kya jayega? Dw will be what? Minus dq. Okay, dw will be minus dw. What it is representing means we are doing work. When work will be negative? When you are doing work on the system. So performing the shaft work is the right answer. And from your own observation also, you can answer ki if you are like this internal energy equal to this dq, the internal energy equal to dq for which case, guys? If work is zero. If you are not doing any work, the change in internal energy will be equal to the heat addition. If you are adding heat, internal energy is going to increase. If you are removing heat, the internal energy is going to decrease if there is no work transfer. But if there is work transfer, then the increase internal energy is going to increase if this is work is doing on the system. Heat addition or ye ho jayega aapka, means we are doing additional work. Okay, we are doing additional work. Then only if this is dq, so dq will be what? Du, and work is what? Work is also minus dq. Then you will have du equal to 2dq. Are you getting the idea? So means we are doing work on the system. Option D is the right answer for this. Next question. If a gas vapor is allowed to expand through a very minute aperture, then such process is known as. If a gas is no. Vinod, why you are saying in closed system work is zero? Closed system work is not zero. Closed system work is integration PdV. W closed system equal to integration PdV. So closed system work is zero only if dV is zero. If the boundaries of a closed system are not expanding, if you are having a rigid container, closed rigid container, then work will be zero. Okay, so if dV is zero for a closed system, then work will be zero. But closed system boundaries can expand. If boundaries of a closed system are expanding, work is said to be done by the system because dV is positive. And if boundaries of a closed system are contracting, it means work is done on the system. So you cannot say closed system work is zero. Are you getting the idea, Vinod? For ideal gas, option C. Kaun sa kare ho? Acha, next question. A gas vapor, this is gas vapor, not ideal gas. This is gas vapor, guys. A gas vapor hai, is allowed to expand through a very minute aperture. Then such a process is known as what? This process ko kya bologe aap? A gas is expanding through a small aperture. So this is known as throttling process, guys. Hum bolenge throttling. Free expansion ki nahi bolenge? Because this is not a expansion through what? Vacuum. You're not expanding a gas against vacuum. The expansion of a gas against vacuum is known as free expansion. Okay. But the gas is not expanding. The gas is actually passing through some kind of small aperture, some kind of orifice. Okay. Koi orifice hai ya koi porous plug hai. The gas, if it is passed through some kind of porous plug, some kind of orifice, koi orifice hai. So suppose this is pressure P1, this is pressure P2. And you know, P2 will always be less than P1. And enthalpy is going to remain constant. Okay. So this process is known as throttling process, not free expansion. So free expansion ke saath mix nahi karna hai. This process is known as throttling process. The gas, if a gas, any gas, like if it is a real gas or non-real gas, koi zaruri nahi hai. If you are getting out throttling of a real gas, the temperature is going to remain constant. Why? Because for ideal gas, If you are carrying out throttling, the temperature will remain constant. Why? For ideal gas, if enthalpy is constant and enthalpy is function at temperature only, so if ideal gas, enthalpy is constant, temperature will also remain constant. But for real gas, temperature can increase or decrease. If the Joule Thomson coefficient of that gas is positive, you will get the cooling effect, means temperature is going to decrease. And if the Joule Thomson coefficient of that gas is negative, then for that real gas, temperature is going to increase. Heating ho jayega. Okay. So for real gas, temperature can increase or decrease based on the Joule Thomson coefficient. Ab kuch gases hoti hain like helium. Okay, hydrogen, they are having a negative Joule Thomson coefficient. Unka jo inversion temperature hai, maximum inversion temperature, that is very low. Maximum inversion temperature for some of the gases like hydrogen, helium is very low. That's why when you will carry out throttling of those gases, their temperature increases, heating ho jata hai unka. But for most of the gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, their maximum inversion temperature is very high. Okay, so at atmospheric temperature, if you will check their Joule Thomson coefficient, that will be positive and you will get the cooling effect. Okay. Next question. A refrigerator operates between condenser temperature 27, evaporator temperature -23. What is the COP? Again, very simple question, guys. Chalo. Thank you. Okay, so guys, evaporator temperature is given to us -23 means 250 Kelvin. Condenser temperature is given to us +27 means 300 Kelvin. So what is COP? COP reversible, yeah, Carnot refrigerator. Carnot refrigerator, that is equal to T lower by T higher minus T lower. So if you put all the values, what is T lower? It is evaporator temperature 250. What is T higher? 300 minus 250. So if you will solve, you will get 5 as the answer. Means option C is the right answer for this question. Option C is the right answer, guys. 6 kahan se aa gaya bachon? Refrigerator ki baat kar raha hai. For heat pump, COP of heat pump is equal to T higher by T higher minus T lower. So this is 300 by 300 minus 250. This is equal to 6. Or what you can say, COP of heat pump equal to 1 plus COP of refrigerator. But he is not asking you for refrigerator heat pump. He is asking you a refrigeration cycle. So for refrigeration, this is the COP. So aisa mistake mat karo bachon. Aisa mistake nahi karna chahiye aapko. Theek hai? 16%, Rohit is saying 16%. So kya, you are taking temperature in Celsius? Rohit, aisa mistake mat karo bache. I think you are taking temperature in degree Celsius, that's why you are getting that 16%. In this expression, always we use temperature in Kelvin. T lower by T higher minus T higher by T higher minus T lower. This is COP of heat pump, Carnot COP. And this is for Carnot refrigerator. What are the advantage of water tube boiler over fire tube boiler? Water tube boiler kya hota hai? These are high pressure boiler. High pressure. High pressure boiler hota hai water tube boiler. Okay. Or when you are circulating the water at high pressure, then the deposition will be comparatively less. Okay. So deposition, sediment deposition to kam hogi. More effective heat transfer hoga. Steam at higher pressure. Yes. Because when you are supplying the water at high pressure, you will be able to produce steam at high pressure. So the right answer for this question is A and B. D is the right answer, guys. Simple si cheez hai. In tubes, when you are supplying the water at high pressure pe if water is circulating, what will happen? The deposition will be less. Okay. If the tubes, in tubes, water is flowing at a very slow rate. Both slow rate pe water agar flow kar raha hai, then deposition will be more. Okay. So in high pressure boiler, the deposition will be less. Steam will be produced at high pressure and more effective will be the heat transfer. So only A and B are right. So D is the right answer, guys. Note C. Har jagah ye dekh ke mat answer karo ki all ho jayega sir, A, B, C. Theek hai? Chaliye. Can you give me some example of high pressure boiler? Main aapko ek example deta hun. Low pressure boiler ka agar aapko example dena hai, low pressure. Jitne bhi fire tube boiler hai, all are low pressure boiler. Like Cochrane boiler, locomotive boiler, all fire tube boilers are low pressure boiler. Okay. Naturally circulated जो आपका boiler है, जो Babcocks and Wilcox boiler है, it is a water tube boiler, but there is no forced circulation. उसमें क्या होता है? Natural circulation. So means we have not attached any kind of pump to circulate water inside the boiler. The circulation of water is due to density difference. Natural circulation बोलते हैं. So that fall under the category of medium pressure boiler. Okay. High pressure boiler में क्या हो जाएगा? Water will be supplied at very high pressure. Okay, at very high pressure we are supplying water, and when we are supplying water at very high pressure, the steam will be also produced at high pressure. So, कुछ criteria होता है, like 20 megapascal से अगर आपका pressure कम है, then that boiler is known as low pressure. 20 to 80, that is medium pressure. 80 to more than like you can say 180, 80 से 180 के आसपास है, that is high pressure boiler. And the, if the pressure is more than critical temperature, critical pressure. What is the critical temperature for water, guys? 373. Close to 374 degrees Celsius. If the boiler is operating above the critical temperature, critical pressure, what is the critical pressure? That is close to 22 megapascal or 221 atmospheric. So if a boiler is operating above critical point, critical temperature, then that boiler is known as super critical boiler. And what is the example? Benson boiler. Okay. So Benson boiler ko aap kya bol sakte ho? Super critical boiler. So there is a particular segregation based on the pressure only. At what pressure you are producing steam, you can classify boilers into different categories. Theek hai? Next question, guys, in front of you. With an increase in thickness of insulation, agar aap thickness of insulation badhate hain, like suppose this is any pipe and you provided some kind of insulation over it. Aapne iske upar kuch insulation de di. This is your pipe and you provided the insulation. Okay. So if you provided the insulation, the surface area is going to increase. And with the increase in surface area, the convection resistance 1 by HA, that is going to decrease. As you will increase the area, the convection resistance is going to decrease. Always R convection, convection resistance always decreases with the increase in area. Okay. And due to increase in area, this thickness as it is increasing, okay, conduction resistance delta, you can say, suppose in this cylinder, if you write it here, ln of R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KL. Okay, this is your conduction resistance. So conduction resistance is always going to increase. R thermal conduction always increases. With the increase in the insulation, conduction resistance always increases. Convection resistance always decreases. But their net resistance, R total means R conduction plus R convection, that can increase or decrease. It depends on the critical radius. Okay, so if critical radius is less than outer radius, the critical radius is less than outer radius, so the R total will increase. Total resistance will increase. Okay, and if the outer radius is less than critical radius, then R total will decrease. R total kya karega bachcho? It will decrease. Are you getting the idea? Okay, let me draw here plot also so that you will be able to recall. Here you can draw something like this. This is Q, this is R. Okay. And you will have a plot something like this. So this is your critical radius, RC. So this is your radius. So if you're having RO less than critical radius. So suppose this is RO1. Isko main likhta hu RO1. And as RO1 is less than RC, so heat transfer is going to increase. Why? Because total resistance is decreasing. And if you'll take here RO2, as RO2 is more than RC, the heat transfer is going to decrease. You will fall in the second zone. So what you need to remember, if always providing the insulation, convection resistance decreases, and with the decrease in convection resistance, Q convection kya karega bachcho? It is going to increase. Q convection is always going to increase with the increase in the in conduction resistance. Always Q conduction is going to decrease. But the net heat transfer can increase or decrease. It depends on the critical radius. If the outer radius is lower than the critical radius, the total resistance is going to decrease and heat transfer is going to increase. And if the outer radius is more than the critical radius, the total resistance is going to increase and the Q is going to decrease. Okay, so lots of question can be asked from this particular concept. So, abhi usne aapse kya pucha hai? Thickness badhane se kya hoga? Increasing the thickness of insulation, convection increase karega, bilkul. And conduction decrease करेगा, तो option A is the right answer, guys. Option A ही क्या हो जाएगा? this will be the right answer. Okay. Yes, guys, is that clear? Ye clear hai question? Please check and confirm. Okay. Critical radius kya hota? Let me tell you that also, guys. Critical radius of insulation, RC, that is equal to K by H for pipe. K by, where K is the conductivity of the insulation, H is the outside convection heat transfer coefficient, and RC equal to 2K by H. This is for sphere. For sphere, spherical vessel, it is 2K by H, where K is the conductivity of the insulation material and H is the outside convection heat transfer coefficient. So, if you want, you can write KI here, you can write HO here. KIHO. KI means conductivity of the insulation, not the pipe material. You need not to take conductivity of the pipe material. You need to take conductivity of the insulation divided by outside convection heat transfer coefficient. Okay, so if you will take any pipe, if you will insulate it with some kind of material, always conduction resistance increases, convection resistance decreases. Due to decrease in the convection resistance, Q convection increases. Due to increase in the R conduction, Q convection decreases. But net heat transfer can increase or decrease. It depends on the critical radius. Critical radius, more than the outer radius, heat transfer is going to increase. Critical radius, less than the outer radius, heat transfer is going to decrease. I hope you got the point. Chaliye. Compressed air coming out from a punctured football. आपने एक फुटबॉल को पंचर्ड कर दिया और कंप्रेस्ड एयर इज कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम ए कंप्रेस्ड टैंक. नारायण, इज दैट क्लियर? नारायण, यस, प्लीज कंफर्म. नारायण, इज दैट क्लियर? रोहित, अगेन यू आर मेकिंग द मिस्टेक. दोनों ड्रॉप होंगे. नो रोहित, प्लीज बी वेरी क्लियर विद योर कॉन्सेप्ट. बहुत क्लियर आपको करना पड़ेगा कॉन्सेप्ट. ओके, गुड नारायण, थैंक यू. चलिए, if a gas is coming out from a punctured football, aapne football ko punctured kar diya and compressed air is coming out from that. Okay, ab kuch bacche sochenge, sir, it is a kind of free expansion process and air is a ideal gas, so temperature constant rahega. Air is, we treat it as a ideal gas. It is not an ideal gas, it is a real gas. When you are carrying out expansion of a real gas, air, the temperature is going to decrease. Aapko pata hai, pressure decrease karta hai, to temperature kya karega aapka? That is also going to decrease. Okay. Expansion may, when you are expanding a gas, the temperature is going to decrease. You know about expansion, isentropic expansion? When you are isentropically expanding a gas, what happened? The pressure is going to decrease and temperature is also going to decrease. So, like, if you will take, like, simply you can observe, if you will put, like, that example, you can easily get in refrigeration. If you will make some kind of nozzle with your lips, something like this, you can easily observe, like if air is expanding, you will get the cold air here. Aapko yahan pe kya milegi? Cold air. Aur agar yahan pe aap kya karoge? Pressure badhaoge. Like area if you will increase, like the diffuser. Diffuser mein area kya hota hai? Jyada hota hai. Something like this. This is diffuser. To apne muh ko open karke, agar aap aise karoge, you will get the hot air. Hot air. And if you will make it a nozzle, you will get the cold air. Why? Because nozzle mein kya hoga? Nozzle mein something like this. The velocity is going to increase and the pressure is going to decrease. With the drop in pressure, the temperature is going to decrease. Very easily you can analyze. And if you will take a compressed tank, DO hota na, DO. DO mein kya hota? Compressed liquid hota hai. And when we spray that DO over our bodies, again you can feel some kind of coldness. Why? Because when a liquid is expanding, again it will result in its decrease in temperature. Similarly, if you will take a compressed air, okay, compressed air at a high temperature, if you expand it, again its temperature is going to decrease. So air is going to become cooler. Option B is the right answer, not A. Option B is the right answer. Chaliye. Next question hai, meri khayal se abhi ye next kuch shuru ho gaya question. To ye question hamara aa jayega 26th question hai ye. Okay, 26th question. थोड़े से अलग क्वेश्चन मिलेंगे आपको, बट दे आर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग वन. बहुत अच्छे क्वेश्चन है बच्चों. क्वेश्चन नंबर 26. थ्री डिस्क एबीसी, देयर आर थ्री डिस्क एबीसी, 2 मीटर, 4 मीटर, 6 मीटर, आर कोटेड विद कार्बन ब्लैक. तीनों पे आपने कार्बन ब्लैक की कोटिंग की हुई है. ऑन देयर अदर सर्फेसिस द वेवलेंथ कोरस्पॉन्डिंग टू मैक्सिमम इंटेंसिटी, दिस इज लैम्डा एम. Wavelength corresponding to maximum intensity. Lambda M1 is 300 nanometer. Lambda M2 is 400 nanometer. Lambda M3 is 500 nanometer. So, bol raha hai, in which case the power radiated by them will be what? QA, QB, QC will be what? What is the relationship between QA, QB and QC? What is the relationship between QA, QB and QC? All three will be same, or which one will be higher? Okay, you know guys, black body ka jo hemispherical emissive power hai, that is directly proportional to its fourth power of its absolute temperature. The hemispherical emissive power of a black body is directly proportional to its fourth power of its absolute temperature. So more is the temperature, more is the hemispherical emissive power. So what do you feel? Which one is having high temperature? This is A, this is B, this is C. Which one is having high temperature, guys? Which one is emitting radiations of the shorter wavelength? Out of these three, which one is emitting the radiations of shorter wavelength? This one is emitting the radiations of the shorter wavelength. So iska jo temperature hoga, temperature of A, this will be the highest. Out of these three bodies, guys, this is the body which is having highest temperature. How you can say that? Sir, we know about Wien's displacement law. The wavelength corresponding to maximum spectral emissive power into the temperature, that is equal to constant. Okay. Or wavelength emitted is equal to 1 by T. High is the temperature, low is the wavelength. Sun emits radiations of shorter wavelength. Okay. And our low temperature body like human body, earth, they emit radiations of the higher wavelength. That is the reason when radiations are coming from the sun, those greenhouse gases, they actually work as a transparent body for those short wavelength radiation. So easily those radiations penetrate our atmosphere. But when radiations are emitted by our earth, those greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, they does not allow those high wavelength radiation to go out. That's why the temperature of our earth is continuously increasing. That is known as the greenhouse effect. Due to that continuous increase in temperature of the earth, that sea level is increasing and average temperature of earth is also increasing. That is a cause, you can say, that is a major concern nowadays. Okay, so lambda m will be less if the temperature is high. So observing these three bodies, you can easily say ki this A body is having highest temperature, so iska jo emissive power hoga, that will be more. This, or what you can say, E A will be highest. So what is the right answer, guys, for this question? Option A is the right answer. Achha question tha, is tarah ka question bhi pucha ja sakta hai. Option A is the right answer. Okay, chaliye, let us move to the next question, guys. Question number 27. Which one of the following statement holds good for the equation? Which of the following equation holds good? प्रदीप यार, एक इसको ना कोई बंदा है, जैसे एक एक बंदा है, उसको रिमूव कर यार, नेक ये कुछ आ रहा है, कुछ उसमें ना कमेंट आ रहे हैं, कोई बात नहीं, बच्चों को ना थोड़ा सा आ रही है। इसको एक बार इसको ब्लॉक कर दे यार। देख अभी नीचे, हाँ इसको ब्लॉक कर देना, रिमूव तो मैंने कर दिया बट ब्लॉक होना चाहिए ताकि कमेंट ना कर पाए ना। बस ये दिख तो रहा है, ये ऊपर 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 ये वाले, हाँ ये वाले, ये वाले, ये वाले। ओके, चलिए। So this equation, guys, you know, dq equal to du plus dw. This is the first law of thermodynamics. dq equal to de plus dw. This is first law of thermodynamics, guys. And this you can write for any system, any system, any process. This is applicable to any system, any process. Okay. Agar main yahan pe change kar dun, let me change here. Like if I will neglect the kinetic and potential energy changes. So if I write it here, dq equal to du plus dw. This equation. Neglecting kinetic and potential energy changes. Neglecting kinetic energy
and potential energy changes. Okay, like if you assume a stationary system. Okay, so this is now applicable to what? Closed system, any process. Closed system, any process. dq equal to du plus dw, closed system, any process. Okay, further, if I will assume it here, dq equal to du plus pdv. Differential form, guys, I'm writing the differential form. So this is now applicable to closed system and reversible only. Closed system, reversible. So if you're having here work PDV, that is applicable to reversible. DU means closed system. DQ equal to DU plus DW, closed system, reversible. DQ equal to DU plus DW, closed system, any process. And this equation, DQ equal to DE plus DW, this is for any process, any system. So for this question, the right answer is any process, and for any system, option B is the right answer, guys. Option B is the right answer for this question. Kishore, please check your answer. I mean, mixed answer are. Kishore is saying A, Ashutosh is saying B, and Rohit is saying C. Guys, this equation DQ equal to DE plus DW, this is applicable to any system, any process. Please confirm, is that clear, guys? Ye clear hai aapko? Yes, Rohit and Kishore. And others also, guys, if you are having any query, please confirm. So you need to remember, this is applicable to closed system, any process, this one, closed system, any process, and DQ equal to DU plus PDV, closed system, reversible. Chaliye. Next question, guys, thoda sa jaldi karte hain isko, so that last mein main aapka query bhi le lunga kuch. So this is, I think, 28. When the energies are built to withstand the same, When the engines are built to withstand the same thermal and mechanical stresses. When the engines are built to withstand same thermal and mechanical stresses. Same mechanical thermal stress means same peak temperature, P max or P peak. That is same. Or P max is also same. So same maximum pressure, same maximum temperature. So for this condition, always diesel efficiency will be more than dual and auto will be the least. For same compression ratio, always auto cycle efficiency will be more than dual and diesel will be the least. But for same thermal and mechanical stresses means for same peak, because if a two engines, if they are subjected to same peak temperature, peak pressure, then only they are going to withstand same kind of thermal and mechanical stresses. So if mechanical and thermal stresses are same, means peak pressure, peak temperature is same, it means efficiency of diesel will be always highest. So option A is the right answer for this question. Okay, guys, chaliye, let us quickly move to next question. A diesel engine has a compression ratio of 18. R equal to 18, cutoff takes place at 5% of the stroke. Cutoff takes place at 5% of the stroke. The fuel cutoff ratio is, what is the cutoff ratio? You know, guys, cutoff volume V3 equal to V2 plus X by 100 into VS. Or you can write it something like this also. V3 equal to V2 plus X by 100 into V1 minus V2. Just remember this relationship. Cutoff ratio, cutoff volume. In diesel cycle, if you will draw here the pressure, here volume, this is the constant pressure line, something like this. And here if you will mark, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4. So V3 is nothing but V3, this volume, guys, this volume, V3. So V3 is nothing but V2, okay. And what is this? This is X percent. What is this, guys? This is V2, this volume is V2. This volume is V2, okay. And we want this. Hamein toh chahiye ye. We want this volume, V3. We want this volume. So this is V2. And what is this, guys? This volume is X percent of VS, means X percent of V1 minus V2. Because V1 minus V2 is known as cutoff volume. V1 minus V2 is known as swept volume. So this is X percent. Okay, this remaining, not, yes, this remaining. Okay, this remaining. Let me correct this. Because what we want, guys? We want V3. So V3 to ye hoga aapka. Let me correct this. So this is V3. okay, this is V3, guys. This is what? This is X percent. This is X percent of V1 minus V2. Okay, so this is V2. This is X percent of V1 minus V2. And this is V3. So V3, we can write it as V2 plus X percent of V1 minus V2. Because this entire volume is known as V1 minus V2. This is V1 minus V2. Okay, this is V1, entire is V1. This is V2 and this is V1 minus V2. Okay, and this is X percent of V1 minus V2. This is V2. So we can write it here V3 equal to V2 plus X percent means X by 100 of V1 minus V2. So this you need to remember, guys. Ye aapko directly remember rakhna chahiye. Okay, and if you are able to remember this, if you will divide both sides by V2, you can write it here V3 by V2, which is nothing but rho equal to 1 plus X by 100 into V1 by V2 is R minus 1. So easily you will be able to get this relationship. Okay, so main yahan likh deta hu cutoff ratio rho equal to 1 plus X by 100 into R minus 1. Agar aap ye yaad rakhna chahte ho to this also you can directly remember. So using this, if you will write it here, rho equal to 1 plus, what is X? X is 5%, so 5 by 100 into R minus 1. R is what? 18 minus 1 is 17. Okay, so 17 ko isse karoge, you will get what? 17 panche aapke ho jayenge 85, so you will get 0.8. Okay, so 1 plus 0.8, you will get what? 1.85. Okay, 1.85. So option B is the right answer for this question. Option B will be the right answer for this question, guys. Please check and confirm. Is that clear, guys? Yeah, very good, Vinod. Your answer is now right. Very good. So I discussed with you the concept also. What is the concept? V3 cutoff volume is equal to V2 plus X percent of this. Any X percent, it may be 5%, 10%, any value if it is given to you, or directly you can remember this relationship. Rho equal to 1 plus X by 100 into R minus 1. So R, if you will put 70 multiplied by 5 by 100, you will get 0.85. 1 plus 0.85, you will get the answer 1.85. Chaliye. Next question, guys, in front of you. The adjacent VT diagram. The VT diagram is given to you. The VT diagram is given to you. This is a VT diagram. This is question number 30th. 30th question hai hamara. The VT diagram is given to you. What is the relationship between P1 and P2? What is the relationship between P1 and P2? Both are equal. P2 is greater than P1. P2 is less than P1 and cannot be predicted. Can you predict, guys? Can you predict what is the relationship between P1 and P2? Both are equal. P1 is less than P2, P2 is greater than P2, or there is no such relationship possible. So, isko kaise answer karoge? You know, guys, ideal gas PV equal to MRT. So, on VT diagram, this is representing constant pressure line P2. This is representing constant pressure line P1. How we can say that? Because slope is constant. This slope is constant. So, this is a constant pressure line. This is another constant pressure line P2. Okay, so V equal to MR P by P. Okay, so agar main yahan likhun del V by del T for constant P. Del V by del T for constant P. What is this? Sir, this is MR by P. This is MR by P. Okay, and what is MR by P, guys? This is nothing but V by T. This is nothing but V by T. Okay, so observing this, okay, even there is no need of this, iski bhi zarurat nahi hai. So the slope on the volume versus temperature diagram, from this you can say ki del V by del T is inversely proportional to pressure. Because MR is constant, this you can write it as C by P. M, mass is constant, R is characteristic gas constant, that is also constant. Okay, that is also constant. So what you can say, observe from this, what you can observe from this, sir, this slope is inversely proportional to pressure. And if slope is inversely proportional to pressure, means if the slope is more means the pressure is less. It means P2 is less than P1. P1 is the high pressure, because if pressure is more, the slope will be less. And if pressure is less, the slope will be high, because slope is inversely proportional to pressure. So P2 is less than P1. So right answer is what? Option C is the right answer. Option C is the right answer for this question. P1 is greater than P2, Vinodi. Very good. Bilkul sahi hai aapka answer. Okay, guys. तो थोड़ा सा सोचना है दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन, लाइक बहुत नया क्वेश्चन हो सकता है एंड देर कैन बी चांसेस. ओके, अब इसको वो अलग अलग तरह से पूछ सकता है. ही कैन टेक प्रेशर टेम्परेचर डायग्राम, वॉल्यूम टेम्परेचर, समथिंग लाइक दैट. देर कैन बी लोड्स ऑफ वेरिएशन इन दिस. So what you need to think, if it is a VT diagram, then you need to think of del V by del T. If it is a PV diagram, then you need to take del P by del V. And if it is a PT diagram, then you need to think of del P by del T. Chaliye. Next question. A heat engine has an efficiency, this. The temperature of the source and sinks are decreased by 100. Both temperature of source and sink you are decreasing by 100. The temperature of source and sink both are decreased by 100. Then what is the change in efficiency? The efficiency is going to increase, decrease, remain constant, and it will become 1. What you will answer, guys? You know, efficiency of a heat engine is equal to 1 minus T lower by T higher. Ab isko yahan tak nahi rakhna hai. Further you can write it as T higher minus T lower by T higher. तो इसको अगर आपने 100 से डिक्रीज कर दिया तो टी हायर माइनस 100, इसको भी आपने 100 से डिक्रीज कर दिया डिवाइड बाय टी हायर माइनस 100, तो ऊपर तो क्या आएगा, न्यूमरेटर विल बी सेम, टी हायर माइनस 100 माइनस टी लोअर प्लस 100, दिस विल बी टी हायर माइनस 100, सो दिस विल कैंसिल आउट, सो दिस विल बी टी हायर माइनस टी लोअर बाय टी हायर माइनस 100. सो व्हाट विल हैपन गाइस, the efficiency is going to decrease. Why? Sir, denominator badh raha hai. Denominator is what? This is decreasing. Ye kya kar gaya? Decrease kar gaya. To aapka kya ho jayega? Sorry, let me write it here. Because we are increasing the what? Main isko correct kar deta hu. Kya changes aayenge isme? Let me check again also. So this is the case we are getting. Initially, this is the efficiency. Efficiency 1. Heat engine efficiency 1 is T higher minus T lower by T higher. Okay, and now you are having this term lower than that. आपका ये क्या कर गया? Decrease कर गया है. Okay, and if this is decreased, ये आपका क्या कर गया? Decrease कर गया है. So efficiency is going to increase. So we are going with option A. Option A will be the right answer, guys. Both are decreasing, but efficiency is going to increase. Option A is right. Okay, guys. Ashutosh, Pirveen and Parihar, Rohit. परिहार का ठीक है, रोहित योर आंसर इज रॉन्ग है ना, आपको सी नहीं है, ऑप्शन ए इज द राइट आंसर. यस, इंक्रीजेस. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ दिस टर्म इज डिक्रीजिंग, दिस इज डिक्रीजिंग, समथिंग लाइक दिस गाइस, 5/3, 5/4 and 5/3. तो अगर ये टर्म डिक्रीज किया है तो दिस टर्म इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. 5/3 इज मोर, ये आपका क्या हो जाएगा, दिस विल बी मोर देन दिस. ओके, तो एफिशिएंसी आपका क्या करेगा, इट इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. ऑप्शन ए इज द राइट आंसर फॉर दिस. Next question in front of you. For cooking food, which of the following type of utensil is most suitable? For cooking food, which of the following type of utensil is most suitable? Kis tarah ka utensil aap use karoge? If you want to cook food, what type of? हाँ ठीक है, सम कुछ वैल्यू कंसीडर करके भी कर सकते हो. बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, कुछ वैल्यू कंसीडर करके भी कर सकते हो. बट एक्चुअली आई एक्सप्लेन यू थ्रू दिस पर्टिकुलर कंसेप्ट. T higher, this is going to remain same and this is going to decrease. Okay, you can take some value also. For cooking food, which of the following type of utensil is most suitable? Kis tarah ka utensil most suitable hai for cooking food? High conductivity, obviously. Like if you want to cook food, this material is required to be what? Conductivity higher hona chahiye. Then only it will be able to transmit heat to the food stuff. This is the flame actually, suppose something like this. Okay. मान लीजिए आपका क्या है, फ्लेम आ रहा है. सो इफ यू, व्हेन यू विल बी एबल टू ट्रांसमिट हीट, हीट इफेक्टिवली कब ट्रांसफर होगा, व्हेन कंडक्टिविटी इज हाई. कंडक्टिविटी क्या होना चाहिए, हाई होना चाहिए. एंड एट द सेम टाइम हीट कैपेसिटी इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी लो, मीन्स सीपी क्या होना चाहिए, कम होना चाहिए, ताकि हीट कैपेसिटी क्या हो, कम हो. हीट कैपेसिटी इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी लोअर, कंडक्टिविटी इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी हायर. देन व्हाट यू कैन से, हाई स्पेसिफिक हीट, लो स्पेसिफिक हीट एंड हाई थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी. ऑप्शन डी इज द राइट आंसर. स्टोरेज कम होना चाहिए, स्टोरेज लेस होना चाहिए, और कंडक्टिविटी क्या होना चाहिए, हाई होना चाहिए. दैट इज द कंडीशन, दैट इज अ रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर ए गुड यूटेंसिल फॉर कुकिंग फूड. सो ऑप्शन डी इज द राइट आंसर गाइस. ओके, डी इज द राइट आंसर. चलिए ठीक है, लेट मी चेक योर कमेंट्स. हाँ, यू कैन से ओके, अल्फा अल्फा होता है आपका थर्मल डिफ्यूजिविटी. इफ अल्फा इज मोर, फास्टर विल बी द हीट डिफ्यूजन थ्रू अ पर्टिकुलर मटीरियल. मोर इज द अल्फा, मोर इज द हीट faster diffuses through a particular material. Okay, what is alpha? Alpha is known as K by rho Cp, and the ratio of nu by alpha, that is known as the Prandtl number. Momentum diffusivity to the thermal diffusivity, that is known as Prandtl number. Prandtl number for gases is equal to 1. Prandtl number for air equal to 0.69. Prandtl number for water is in the range of 7 to 13. Okay, something like this. For gases, delta equal to delta thermal. For air, ye bhi almost same honge. For water, delta is more than delta thermal. Okay, Prandtl number, liquid metals. Liquid metals like mercury is very low. It is 0.001, something like this. Very low. So, both kam hota hai. So, delta thermal is more than delta. Prandtl number for heavy oils. Heavy oils. It is also very high, in the range of 1 lakh. 10,000, 1 lakh ke aas pass hota hai. And for this case, delta will be very, very high as compared to delta thermal. Delta will be very, very high as compared to delta thermal, where delta is the hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness and delta thermal is the thermal boundary layer thickness. So, kuch cheeze hain jo aap recall yahan se kar sakte ho. Chali, is question ko dekhte hain. What is the question? Which of the following process convection does not take place primarily? There are four cases given to us: sand and land breezes, boiling of water, warming of glass of bulb due to filament, heating of air around a furnace. In which case, convection is not the primarily mode of heat transfer? What do you answer, guys? In which case, convection is not the primarily mode? Please try to answer. Yes, warming of glass bulb by filament. So, yahan pe kya ho jayega? Yahan pe radiation is going to dominate. Radiation kya karega? Dominate karega. So, convection will not be there. But if you are heating air around a furnace, boiling kar rahe ho, so boiling is also a case of convection. Special case of convection where phase change is going to take place. Sea and land breezes, that is also a case of convection. Air jo aapka flow karta hai, air flows due to convection only. Okay. So, only option C is the case where there will not be any primarily convection. Convection will not be there actually. That is not going to dominate. Which of the following is a path function? Very simple one line question. Ek line ka simple sa question hai. Which of the following is a path function? In mein se path function kaun sa hai bacho? Yes, very good. D is the right answer. Bilkul sahi. Why? Sir, dq equal to dE plus dW, and this dE is a property, energy, and this is equal to dq minus dW. So, this is a property. Ye property hota hai aapka. This is a property. Okay. So, dq minus dW, this is not a path function because all properties are point function. All properties are point function. So, heat, work, this also, these are what? Path function. So, this is the quantity which is not a path function because this is a property. Ye kya hai? Property hai, and all properties are point function. So, option D is the right answer for this. Next question, guys, in front of you. In a reversible isothermal expansion process, fluid expand from 10 bar 2 meter cube to 2 bar 10 meter cube during the process, heat supplied is this. What is the rate of work transfer? In a reversible isothermal process, fluid expand from 10 bar 2 meter cube to 2 bar 10 meter cube during the process, heat supplied is 1000 kilowatt. What is the work done during this process? You know, guys, dq equal to du plus dW. Okay, so if there is no heat transfer, the process is isothermal. So for ideal gas, we assume ideal gas only, because for real gas we don't know like how to solve, because most of the cases we solve with ideal gases only. So we are going with that. Ideal gas dU is zero. Okay, real gases, you know, du is a function of what? That is a function of volume and temperature. So you will have some other terms also other than Cv dt. Okay, so that can change. So for ideal gas, temperature constant, du will be zero. Okay, so whatever heat you are supplying, that is equal to work transfer. So there is no need to solve this question. You can go with 100 kilowatt. D is the right answer, guys. There is no need to solve even. Okay, D is the right answer for this question, 100 kilowatt. Next question. Which of the following is correct in context of thermal diffusivity of liquid and gases? What is thermal diffusivity? It is the ratio of K by rho Cp. Alpha will be more if conductivity is high and heat capacity, heat storage is less. Okay, alpha is more, faster is the heat diffusion. Faster heat diffusion. Faster is the heat diffusion. A body acquires the, you can say, hot bath temperature very quickly if alpha is more. Like suppose if you will pass air over any kind of hot surface, the air is going to acquire that hot surface temperature more quickly as compared to water. Why? Because alpha is more for air. Are you getting? Like if you will pass water over any kind of surface, the water will not be able to gain that surface temperature more quickly as compared to air. So air bahut jaldi garam ho jata hai. Like if you will observe in summers, air heated up very quickly. Bahut jaldi thanda bhi ho jata hai. Why? Because alpha of air is very high. It is not like that air is going to take more heat. The heat transfer will be more for water. Why? Because water is having more specific heat. But the temperature change will be more for the air. The heat diffusion through the material will be very faster. So water, when you are supplying, the heat diffusion in the material will not be that much faster as compared to the air. Air alpha is more, though very quickly air is going to take that surface temperature. So alpha of gases are generally more than alpha of liquids. So option A is the right answer. Gases ka jo alpha hota hai, that is more. Gases are having what? Low thermal conductivity also, but their heat capacity is also very lower. So alpha is more for gases. Alpha gases ka kya hota hai? Jyada hota hai as compared to liquids. Okay, both alpha and nu, they are having same units. Alpha ka moment, thermal diffusivity and momentum diffusivity, both are having same units. Next question, guys, in front of you. A steam pipe is covered with two layer. Okay, with the better insulating forming the outer part. Steam pipe, ek steam pipe hai. This is a steam pipe. This is covered with two layers. This is layer one. Okay, isko main bol deta hu, this is layer one. Okay, and this is layer two. L2. Okay, and this is L1. This is your pipe. Beech mein kya hai? Pipe hai. What is saying? Steam pipe is covered with two layer of insulating material with better insulating material forming the outside. Better insulated means K2 is less than K1. K2 is less than K1. Better insulator is outside. So if you will interchange these layer, what will happen? The heat conduction is going to decrease, increase, remain unaffected, or may increase or decrease. What is your answer, guys? Yes. So if you are putting better insulator inside will offer more conduction resistance. Okay, so total resistance will be very high. If you are using the battery insulator inside, that is going to offer more conduction resistance. So heat transfer is going to what? Decrease. Battery insulator ko agar andar karoge, to heat transfer aapka kya ho jayega? It is going to decrease. Okay. But in case of plain wall, if you will take a plain wall, something like this. Plain wall mein, if you are using different material. So suppose this is material 1, this is 2, this is 3. So it is, the heat transfer is going to remain unaffected with their respective position. Okay, because yahan pe jo total resistance hoga, total resistance will be R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay, that will be unaffected. Okay, unaffected with their position. Whether you are using battery insulation inside, middle, outside, the total heat conduction is going to remain unaffected in case of plain wall. But in case of cylinder, something like this. In case of cylinder, what is the resistance, guys? Resistance kya hota hai? Thermal resistance ln of R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KL. Okay, so this resistance will be more. If you are using the battery insulator inside, this resistance will be more, and due to resistance more, the heat transfer will be less if you are using battery insulator inside. Okay, so for cylinders, it is good to use battery insulator inside, but for plain wall, you can use insulator anywhere, between, in between, inside, outside, anywhere, where you like. Okay, so battery insulator ko andar leke aaoge, heat transfer will decrease. Why? Because total resistance is going to increase, heat transfer will decrease. Next question, guys, in front of you. After expansion, from a gas turbine, the hot exhaust gases are used to heat the compressed air from a compressor with the help of a cross flow heat exchanger. Open cycle gas turbine mein kya karte hain bachcho? What is open cycle gas turbine? You will have a compressor, something like this. It will take atmospheric air, compress karega, and then these air will go into what? Combustion chamber. Combustion chamber mein kya hoga? Heat addition hoga, and then these will go into the turbine. Turbine mein jayengi, and you will be able to get some kind of work out of this. Okay, this is the diagram for your W net. This is turbine, this is compressor, this is combustion chamber. Okay, this is point one, this is point two, three and four. Okay, but what we are doing, suppose you will pass these gases, further these gases, okay, in a kind of regenerator. Agar aap kisi regenerator mein isko pass kar dete hain, okay, something like this. Suppose this is a regenerator. And if you will allow these gases first to pass through this, in gases ko jo compressor se jo compressed air aa raha hai, first you will heat these gases by passing through this, and then if you will pass these gases into the combustion chamber. Okay, so this is a kind of regenerator. This is the regenerator, guys. So we are recovering some waste heat of the turbine we are recovering. Okay, so this is also a heat exchanger, kind of heat exchanger. Okay, it is a kind of regenerator we are attaching. Regenerator kyun bol rahe, because we are recovering some part of the waste heat. So waste heat which is coming out from the turbine, that we are passing through this heat exchanger to preheat the air before entering to the combustion chamber. Okay, so in this process, this is the heat exchanger which is given to us. Okay, and the effectiveness of this is given to us 0.8. effectiveness of heat exchanger is given to us 0.8. okay, so as it is a cross flow, means we can consider the correction factor close to 1. So we can consider it like a counter flow heat exchanger, and C equal to 1. How we can say C equal to 1? Because what is entering? Air is entering. What is going out? That is also kind of air only. Although that is a exhaust gas, and that will have air also, and some kind of, what you can say, hydrocarbon also. Because here, this is actually a cycle for gas turbine. This is a cycle for open cycle gas turbine. Okay. So in combustion chamber, you are adding some kind of fuel also. So in real case, you will have a waste gas, which is not a pure air, and this is the air which is entering. Okay, but their properties are almost same, and their mass flow rates are also very same, almost same. Why? Because the mass of the fuel added is very less as compared to the mass flow rate of the air. So we can assume mass flow rate of hot means Cp of hot, that is equal to m dot C, Cpc, both are same. Okay, because both side mass rate are almost same, both side specific heats are also almost same, because both side we are having air, and both side mass flow rate is also same. So we can go with a case of counterflow heat exchanger. Counterflow heat exchanger with C equal to 1. So is tarah ke case ke liye yaad rakhna hamesha, counterflow heat exchanger with C equal to 1. In this case, the effectiveness equal to NTU divided by 1 plus NTU. This is a direct relationship which you need to remember. For a counterflow heat exchanger, C equal to 1. This is the relationship. Okay. So you can write it here. Effectiveness is given to you 0.8. So this is NTU divided by 1 plus NTU. So if you will solve this, you will get the expression 0.8 plus 0.8 NTU is equal to NTU. Okay. So aapka answer aa jayega 0.8. equal to 0.2 NTU. So NTU will be what? 4. NTU will be 4, this particular heat exchanger. Okay, is heat exchanger ke liye NTU kitna ho jayega? It will be 4. So the right answer for this question is option B. Option B is the right answer, guys. Please check and confirm, is it clear? Very good, Sunil. Yes, Ashutosh, your answer is also right. So next question in front of you. Question number 39, second last question hamara aaj ke liye. 39th question. Which substance having minimum thermal conductivity? बहुत आसान question है. So some basic idea you need to have. What is the conductivity of water? मैंने बताया भी था आपको एयर का कंडक्टिविटी तो बहुत कम होता है. कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ एयर इज इन द रेंज ऑफ दिस 0.026 वॉट पर मीटर केल्विन. ओके, वाटर का कंडक्टिविटी, बिकॉज यू नो वाटर का तो क्या है, लाइक इन डिफरेंट रीजन यू हैव डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ वाटर, बट इन जनरल यू कैन राइट इट क्लोज टू 0.52 वॉट पर मीटर केल्विन, क्लोज टू दिस. ओके, so as you can observe, plastic is also having low conductivity, rubber is also having very low conductivity, but out of these three, air is the least conductivity. Okay, air se kam conductivity kiska milega aapko? Glass wool ka. Glass wool hai, okay, ya puff hai, polyurethane foam, uska bhi compatible milega polyurethane foam. Okay, so some basic idea you need to have. Question pooch leta wo aapse. Okay, last time usne poocha tha water ka conductivity kya hai. Okay, direct numerical value he asked you. What is the conductivity of water? So, kuch thoda sa idea rakh lena. In these cases, easily you can answer ki air is having least conductivity. And so, option A is the right answer for this question. Last question, guys. Aaj ke session ke liye. Saturated liquid at high pressure P1 having enthalpy, this is total to a pressure P2. At pressure P2, enthalpy of the saturated liquid and saturated vapor are these. The dryness fraction of the water vapor after the throttling process. लास्ट क्वेश्चन है तो काइंड ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल क्वेश्चन, न्यूमेरिकल डेटा क्वेश्चन, बट दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इजी. सो प्लीज ट्राई टू आंसर गाइस, प्लीज ट्राई टू आंसर. ही इज आस्किंग अबाउट द थ्रोटलिंग प्रोसेस, थ्रोटलिंग प्रोसेस, थ्रोटलिंग को टीएच पे शो करना चाहो तो टीएच पे कर सकते हो आप. यू कैन शो इट ऑन टीएच डायग्राम, समथिंग लाइक दिस. So this is pressure P1, okay, this is pressure P2, this is your throttling process. This is 1 to 2 is what? Throttling process. 1 to 2 kya aapka throttling process hai. Okay. Saturated liquid enthalpy here, what is enthalpy guys? H1 is what? 1000 kilojoule per kg, 1000 kilojoule per kg, this is the enthalpy here, saturated liquid, it is expanding, throttling. Pressure P2, saturated liquid and saturated vapor, because you, surely if you are throttling a saturated liquid in mixed region, you are going to have a mixture of saturated liquid and vapor. How you can say that? In VCRS, what we do? Like at the out of condenser, we are having saturated liquid. And when we pass that saturated liquid in through a capillary tube expansion valve, so some liquid converts into vapor. Okay. And when it converts into vapor, due to drop in the pressure, it takes latent heat. Okay. And it stick latent heat from its nearby particle. So that's why the temperature of the total refrigerant decreases and some refrigerant convert into vapor that we need to remove before entering into the evaporator, so that size of evaporator does not increase. Okay, because that refrigerant which is already converted into vapor, that is not going to take what the latent heat from the evaporator. Okay, that's how we remove that refrigerant. Okay, so if you are expanding a saturated liquid, you are going to have a mixture of what? Saturated liquid and vapor. That's why this point I am showing here. So at this particular point, this is the saturated, this is the HG. So here, this is what? This is HF. Okay, and this is HG. So HF and HG are also given to you. This is 800 and this is 2800. This is 800, this is 2800. He is asking you what is the dryness fraction here. He is asking you the dryness fraction here. तो बहुत इजीली आप इस क्वेश्चन को आंसर कर सकते हो. मैं आपको समझाने के लिए इतना टाइम ले रहा हूं, बट दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी वेरी इजी. यू कैन राइट इट हियर H1 इक्वल टू H2, वाई? बिकॉज थ्रोटलिंग इज ए आइसेंथैल्पिक प्रोसेस एंड H2 इक्वल टू HF प्लस X HG माइनस HF. ओके, सो H1 इज गिवन टू अस 1000, HF इज गिवन टू अस 800, दिस वी वांट टू फाइंड आउट. दिस इज 2800 माइनस दिस इज 800. इसको सोल्व करोगे, यू विल गेट द आंसर. सो 1000 इक्वल टू 800 प्लस एक्स इनटू 2000. सो एक्स विल बी 200 डिवाइड बाय 2000. सो यू विल हैव एक्स इक्वल टू 0.1. ड्राइनेस फ्रैक्शन विल बी 0.1. ओके, सो 0.1 इज द राइट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. प्लीज चेक एंड कंफर्म, इज दैट क्लियर गाइस? क्या ये क्वेश्चन क्लियर है आप सबको? सो ऑप्शन ए इज द राइट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, तो एक ही क्वेश्चन है जो मैंने इस तरह का डिस्कस किया है, बाकी रिमेनिंग क्वेश्चन ऑल यू नो दोज आर डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चंस ओनली. आई होप यू गॉट सम इंपॉर्टेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन थ्रू दिस क्लास. वन मोर क्लास वी विल हैव टुमारो गाइस, एंड वी विल ट्राई टू कवर सम मोर इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम थर्मोडायनेमिक्स एंड एप्लीकेशन. ठीक है, सो लेट्स मीट टुमारो अगेन एट सेम टाइम 10 AM. चलिए, नाउ इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी क्वेरी आई कैन टेक 1-2 डाउट्स, एनी जनरल क्वेरी और एनी टेक्निकल डाउट इफ यू आर हैविंग यू कैन रेज योर क्वेरी. यस विनोद, थैंक यू, प्लेजर. यस गाइज, एनी डाउट एनी क्वेरी? यस नारायण, थैंक यू, गुड. चलिए, सेम लाइन वी विल हैव वन मोर सेशन टुमारो एंड वी विल डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम हीट, RAC, आइस इंजन एंड थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. थर्मल एंड थर्मल एप्लीकेशन आई एम गोइंग टू कवर, है ना. चलिए, एनी क्वेरी फ्रॉम यूर साइड गाइज, टेक्निकल, नॉन टेक्निकल, एनी जनरल क्वेरी? चलिए, सो गाइज टाइम इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, सो प्लीज यूटिलाइज इट. ओके, and keep revising further. If you face any kind of difficulty, you can get back to me. Vinod, you can go to our website, you can go to your PDF website and you will find the link. Okay, and easily you will be able to avail test series. Okay, so you need to go to your PDF website, you will find some number over there, and you can directly call on these numbers, surely you will find information. Chali, so guys, thank you very much, have a nice day, keep preparing, good luck, have a nice day.